Evening, hey. Ladies and gentlemen, how are you doing? My name is Tyler Rhoades, and you are watching the Saving Throw show production of Hoy Chummers, and I am your humble game master. My name is Tyler Rhoades. I know I said that previously, but I wanted to reiterate that fact because it's important. We are playing fifth edition Shadowrun tonight, and I have a bunch of lovely players, probably the most handsome players in the industry.
Tyler!
The levels of attractiveness is just off the charts. But you'll see that as we go around and have them introduce ourselves. We'll start off with maybe the most handsome one here, Jesse.
Oh my goodness. Jeepers.
Sorry, guys.
Well, hey,
he's just that good looking. You're also very attractive, but he's...
It goes by beard length.
I'll see you in 3 months.
That's right. Challenge accepted. Yeah.
So, who are you and what do you play?
My name is Jesse Durant, and I am playing our humble face by the name of John, as far as anyone knows, anyway. John.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll do my best to talk our way and sweet talk out of situations and knock out gas people to the face. And
You're real good at that.
Yeah, I knock some people out.
To the face.
Yeah, to the
face. What race is John?
I am an elven person.
Okay, a person of the elven persuasion.
Yes, of a higher class family, but found himself disillusioned with the life of ease and instead seeks excitement and overstimulation.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I dig it. So let's continue on to the right here with who's perhaps the most attractive person sitting at this table.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Yeah, happy Valentine's Day. Spread the love!
Yeah! My name is Chris Willett. I'm happy to be here. I'm a guest to the table for today and next session or something?
Yeah, possibly. We're going to try to... some of you may be surprised to see Chris and
Hi.
Not Kelsey.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, Chris is the
Rest
new Kelsey.
Rest in peace, Kelsey.
I'm just kidding. Kelsey will be back. What we are doing is we are going to rotate this fifth seat in and out for different runs so we can get some different guests, get some different faces on the show, get some diversity to the table.
And I'm here to teach them that that's a terrible idea. So
yes.
That'd be great. I'm currently playing a troll archer / samurai guy named Ludo. He's a ginger whose parents are from Tir na n'og, and looks an awful lot like your favorite big Muppet guy from Labyrinth.
Ooh.
Yeah, but slightly more eloquent. Yeah. Oh, but only slightly.
And we'll still be calling rocks, I hope.
Yeah. Oh, that's the plan.
Yeah.
Not with magic. I'll just be calling. They won't be calling back. It'll be.
Yes.
It'll be great. That's sort of my jam. He's an archer. During the day, he runs a brunch food truck called Deus Ex Machina. and then at night, he sort of tries to do good in the shadows. He's sort of a Robin Hood type. So that's Ludo.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you for that, Chris. And thank you for joining us tonight.
I'm happy
it was
to
a pleasure
here.
To have you. I'm so glad I was able to get you back in the damn seat.
Me too.
And he's a troll?
He's a troll.
He's a troll.
Yeah.
We needed more trolling-ish.
But as a player, my troll accent is bad. So
okay.
I'm going to use my voice, and then in your brain, just hear that.
We can add that in post. Just
great.
Give you a rumble.
Great. Okay.
Give you a rumble.
Yeah. EQ me down. Can you do that?
Yeah. Can we do that actually right now? Can we do it live?
It's in the budget.
We'll do it live.
Burn at home.
Yeah.
Increase your
mic's forward.
Only when he talks.
Yeah. Great. Hand on the button.
All right. And so we will continue in a counterclockwise fashion to the unquestionably most attractive person at the table. That'll be this person.
I don't even have a beard.
I know. No.
I'm the only one
the
without
shortest
a beard.
Beard in the room.
Do we have a makeup budget?
Yeah, we do. And it's only like $30,000.
Do we have a mustache?
It all goes to Sax's hair.
I'll wear one.
Yeah. Sax's CG hair.
That's why we put him in a hat all the time, so that we don't have to pay for the CG hair. Yeah.
I don't think I've ever seen Sax without a hat.
Exactly.
Yeah. Mm. Brilliant.
What's on there? Coincidence?
Well, hi. My name is Makayla. I play our human adept, Ketu. See, what I like to call a magical ninja. So he's like an enhanced guy that likes to hang out also kind of in the shadows. Not real great with people, very straight to the point, gets the job done, but has a weakness with animals. Not a weakness, but like he gets along better with animals. You go to a party. I don't know why he would ever go to a party, but if he were, he'd like say hello to the pets
to
and then
kill
probably
someone.
Just sneak out. Yeah, that's actually why.
I like Michaela's assumption that party equals pets. Like, it's not a party unless there's animals. We need to party together more often.
Neither of us have pets.
I know. Is that why we don't hang out?
Yeah, you have to get a dog.
Get a dog. Makayla will come hang out with you.
It's very true.
You heard it here.
I don't have enough time for a dog, so I'd love if anyone else had dogs.
Yeah. Dog visitor.
The dog visitor. That's a TV show.
Coming soon to Danger Channel.
The dog, she just goes to people's houses. Can I pet your dog? That's my Makayla impression.
True.
She just kind of stands awkwardly, like in silence, just petting a dog. Now owners are kind of standing with the leash, being like,
are you done?
Thanks for coming. Oh no, goodness, yeah. Yeah.
I'm not that bad. If I see someone in public with their dog, I will ask to pet the dog before going in. Oh. I feel like that's something you're supposed to do.
That's good to do. That's good to do.
Yeah.
That seems right. You gotta wing it situation by situation, but it's a good rule of thumb for sure.
Totally. Absolutely. All right. And last but certainly not least. This guy's actually won awards for being handsome. He has them at home. He has pictures of them. Check his Twitter. What's your Twitter again, Nick? It's Sungrowler.
@Sungrowler.
Yeah, he's going to be posting the handsome awards he has.
Oh yeah.
To his Twitter profile. Take it away. Who are you? Who are you playing? And what's your deal?
My name's Nick, aka Sungrowler. I am playing Moonbiter. Moonbiter is the orc street shaman of the gang. I am the magical muscles.
Magic muscles. Right. And what is your race, my man?
I am an orc.
Orc. Very orky. We have a very goblinized group here.
You're here first. I'm an orc.
Very equal opportunity.
Asian orc.
Could I just ride on someone's shoulders for the
yes.
night?
Yeah.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Is Ludo cyber enhanced?
Yeah, but lightly.
Okay.
But not magical.
Okay.
Yeah.
A gentle cyber enhancement.
Just seeing right. where everybody is.
Yeah. Yeah. Cyber bio.
Does anyone? Do you have some, you don't have any.
No.
Yeah, so.
Why would I modify my body with that?
I'm perfect the way I am. I have awards for my handsomeness. Oh, you mean in-game.
Yeah.
So you are the only one that moves lightly.
Moonbiter does too.
Oh, that's right.
No one else.
You're physical adept.
I have some changes to myself.
You're fairly discreet. You're discreetly modified.
Yes.
Cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
A large portion of my body either is riddled with secret holes or gun arms.
Secret holes.
Hashtag red.
Oh yeah.
I love that.
Look how red you are.
I know. I'm just always
secret
red.
Holes.
And riddled with them.
When did this happen? Yeah.
Swiss cheese.
Lousy with secret holes.
Water wall happen.
Oh, water wall. Yeah, that is kind of it's a new, we're testing it out.
I like
and, it. And so far, it's gotten a really positive
does
response.
Chat like it?
Let us know in the chat if you like the water wall.
We have a different color for each show.
It looks like you're over 9,000, Tyler. Yeah.
Over 9,000 likes.
I think of this as the color of magic. That's why it's the chat room.
You're emanating.
Where's
that's right. Fiery blue Kai.
The Shadowrun permission deck.
Yes. All right, well, I have 1 minute. To cover all of the donations and recap what happened last session and do general announcements, which means that is not going to happen. So bear with me. First thing we're going to go over here is the donations that you can do. The donations, if one of our mods, and thank you mods for being the awesome people that you are, can post the donation up in the chat. There's different things that you can do to affect this game. Tonight, and only tonight, we have We have an extra special donation offer.
Ooh.
And I just realized my little thing here is off.
Red. Is that good? That's blinking red.
Blinking red is only good in a 1990s video game.
Okay. Okay. Oh, shit.
What?
Drive didn't... What? Stream communication. Okay, cool. Sorry. Okay, so tonight and only tonight, we have a very, very special event that will get unlocked at the... If we can accrue $60 worth of donations, for thank you, S House Studio, for following the stream. S House Studio, you're a good person, and I love you. Happy Valentine's Day. If we can accrue $60 worth of donations, it unlocks a special event. Now, Dom, are the details of this event available in the chat?
Ooh.
Yes, pretty much.
Okay, cool.
Are you doing that?
They're in the donation.
Yeah, it's beautiful. Yeah.
It is going to be a secret, and we're going to unleash it onto the players, and hopefully it's going to be a lot of fun. Dom is wearing a silly hat. In addition to that, we have our standard donations, which I have modified a little bit because I'm going to tell you what happened last time we had a battle. And one of the challenges that I face when I'm trying to balance battles is seeing how close I can bring the people to death without actually murdering them, but giving them enough of a challenge so that they're not getting bored. And one of the things that disrupts that,
what?
Thank you, Red Nine, for following. Yeah. That's the noise that's gonna play, huh?
That's a gorgeous noise.
That's for followers. Wait till it happens when a subscriber.
Oh my god,
I can't wait.
I need to know.
By the way, the special event that unlocks at $60, if you follow, you get two of the things that I am offering. Does that make sense, Dom?
Nope.
Okay.
No.
$5 unlocks one name. A subscriber unlocks two names. Does that make sense?
What name?
Am I being cryptic enough? What's that?
The secret, for the price of one?
For the price of one. If you subscribe, for the price of one, you get two names. That is such a deal.
It's a great deal. That's a fantastic deal.
I am losing money here, guys.
More names.
Come on.
I completely get what's going on right
You're
now.
You're killing me. All right. So anyway, we're going to briefly and quickly, because I'm now 2 minutes late, go over some of the... what's that? Why are you pointing at
more.
That? I know.
We're
it says I said 2 minutes. I wanted to keep this under 10 minutes, because that's professional.
Now we're getting further behind
That's
us.
What professionals do. They don't get distracted by the
Pick
producer.
The Let's go.
They stay on track. They don't, their players are just sitting there being like, oh fuck, this is taking so long, can we just play already? That is what a professional does.
Sounds like you're stressed out, Tyler.
I think what I'm supposed to do is start stacking dice, right? That's
Yeah. Just to show you're engaged.
It's the international symbol for being engaged.
What I was getting at is the healing in this game is a little bit overpowered, so I've modified it a little bit. When you purchase a med pack,
it's just fine. It was great.
What you have given to these players is essentially it's a potion. They can drink this potion in the middle of combat to either heal themselves physical damage or stun damage. But just giving them the ability to instantly power back up, it was just a little overpowered. And I'm sorry, I know I'm a bad person.
Tyler wants death.
But
what Tyler's saying is he really thinks I should have died in the last game.
He cast a spell against a physical adept. It was him and a physical adept, this wimpy little shaman against a high-powered punching orc.
Yes.
And he gets away with it. It made me mad.
Hey, don't be mad about orc-on-orc violence.
That's true.
And I powered up. Everyone saw me.
Okay. All right.
I was pumped. Yeah.
He looked in the mirror deeply.
That's right. Like,
it was a very dramatic moment. But to make up for that, the med pack not being such a powerful thing, I'm sorry I keep spitting on you, Chris. I'll try to keep it down.
No, don't turn that down. Okay. It's Valentine's Day.
I'm going to aim for... Aim a little bit higher and to the right, because Chris, you're so handsome. To offset that, for one day only, I am going to give a sale to Splooshes, because it's my favorite donation. That is where a person can add up to 3 dice to their dice pool. And you can describe your sploosh, and it's Makayla's favorite. Give Makayla all the splooshes.
One die per sploosh, right?
One die per sploosh. I'm lowering the price to $1.
Okay.
$1 for a sploosh. It's ridiculous. There's going to be like 30 splooshes at this table.
Dollar make you holler.
Okay, I'm not going to go over all the rest of these, but you can check them out. That's just the main thing that I wanted to cover. All right, now that I'm 4 minutes late, on with the recap. What had happened was our group of intrepid Shadowrunners, helmed initially by a gentleman by the name of...
Papa Chops.
Got a job. The job was to travel into the suburbs and locate a recipe of some kind. That's really all it was. Just go to some civilian's house, get a recipe, and bring it back.
And don't kill
without
them.
Hurting anyone.
That was
without
not a stipulation.
It was a stipulation.
How that?
No harm is to come to the family.
The family.
So the interpretation that the Shadowrunners had was. Stun damage doesn't count as harm. So they ended
up... It's got the word damage in the title.
Yeah. Like,
just gonna put that out there.
So they ended up knocking out everybody in the house, including the 6 and the 8-year-old girls.
I did not.
Yes.
What did I do?
Ketu just bitch slapped a 14-year-old. That is all she did.
Backhanded.
She kind of needed it.
Well, it wasn't a bitch slap. It was a backhand.
Yeah.
I stand corrected.
A little stronger.
Yeah.
A little more firm.
Yeah.
He had a gun pointed at John.
It's okay. Let's not argue about who had a gun and who didn't have a gun. Okay. So Ketu backhanded a 14-year-old boy, knocking him unconscious. And they started searching the house. Things started to go south when the dad went home.
That's when it started to go south.
things got pretty bad right away. The dad comes home. A group of Shadowrunners disguised in a van down the street come pouring out and start dragging the dad over to the safe. So rather than engage this mystery group of Shadowrunners in a parlay, they decide to fill them with bullet holes. Because that's what you do.
No questions asked.
It's the best kind of parlay.
Wait a minute. I'm on record as stunning everybody. I filled no one with bullet holes.
Yeah, okay.
I also did not kill anyone.
You just filled them with knife holes.
Right. Not bullet holes.
A bullet hole in someone.
Okay. I stand corrected.
You did or didn't?
I did.
I pulled him into...
Then it's not... He's not completely...
Oh, and you smashed the guy's head in the wrestler, too.
All right.
Yes. So there were knives thrown, bullets.
Throw some knives at the physical depth.
It was a miniature war zone for a good, I don't know, 30 seconds or so.
Forgot about
probably
the...
Probably not even that long.
Bigfoot.
Yes. Yep. And a Bigfoot showed up. And really just kind of stood by and cried because he was a gentle soul. Which you would have found out if you'd have talked to him, but...
Yeah, we would have talked to anyone.
So, eventually, John screamed at this poor man, threatened his life, got him to open up the safe. The runners grabbed the recipe with the smoking ruins and bleeding bodies behind them, got into their van, and went tearing through the suburban neighborhood back out onto the streets. And that is where...
Guys,
we will pick
I think
up
we might be the
story.
Bad guys.
No, we are not.
Are we the baddies?
I had to think about that after I went home. I was like, we're not good.
Yeah, if Shadowrun had alignments, there would be some questions.
But we got the job done.
Yeah.
Kind of.
And you got an existential dilemma for free.
Yes.
That's true. Those normally cost.
I mean, we gave that.
Yeah, those are expensive, typically.
Time effort.
The guy at the gate. Something, and he was real happy. We made that man very happy.
That's true.
You promised him fake furniture. Yeah, you absolutely did.
No, only a fake device, and she gave him a real device.
It was Christopher Walken. He was so happy.
she gave him, like...
He made us had to answer this ridiculous comic riddle that made no sense to anyone.
I get that, though. He didn't know what was happening in that thing, and it was bothering him, and it was bothering me too.
Yes.
That I didn't know.
I just came across it today. Again, I was like, God damn it.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a part that I glazed over because there was a gatekeeper that they had to pass and they had to solve a riddle and it was difficult. Yeah. But check out the previous episode if you want to see that. It was a pretty funny time. So we are going to pick up the action as you are screaming out of the development at English Hill. There does not seem to be any police on you. Gidget is strangely quiet. She seems to have retreated within herself. Maybe she's just been around for people too long, but she's gone full VR mode and she's conked out and she just wants to drive.
Maybe she has robot murder guilt.
Yeah.
I don't know if she has that. No.
Probably not.
I think she's got robot murder hunger.
She's like maybe a little bit of a sociopath, possibly.
Just a little.
Yeah. So where do you guys want to go?
She's cruising down the road with Tracy Chapman in a loop.
Well, we're currently not.
Like any good sociopath.
That's right.
Currently, we're not like out of the woods yet. I feel like.
Possibly not. Did we already paint the van, or did that not happen?
No, you're still driving around that same van.
Let's immediately let's get some cover. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So where to?
Here's what I think was our plan. It's been a while, so I'm not quite sure. But I think that the plan was once, if we came out hot, we were going to. Pull into a parking structure.
Okay.
Swap the plates and the paint and the stuff, and then we drive out as a completely different vehicle.
All right.
In essence.
Yeah.
Cool. Do any of you have navigation?
That's right.
What do or we have? What is that called? It's not navigation.
Map soft.
But yeah, map soft or knowledge Seattle, something like that.
Thought I had navigation.
I have none of these things.
I know my corner of Seattle, Little Mordor.
Little Mordor, but you don't have the general knowledge of Seattle. Let's see if Gidget has anything that would be helpful. Or Grabsy. Hell, Grabsy might know.
Yeah.
Shadow. Oh yeah. Grabsy's got area knowledge.
Come on, Grabsy.
Oh, area knowledge, Seattle 3. Wait, sorry.
You did it! All right. Makayla, I'm proud of you. Okay, so a knowledge is going to be, is it a...
Eight dice.
So roll me some 8 dice then. We'll see if you can find a suitable parking structure for your needs. Something kind of off the road, something you can pull in without having to scan anything.
If we came out of the neighborhood, yeah. Because
you're heading, I guess, west.
Why?
I don't know.
All right, we're heading west.
Are you heading north?
Where's
you tell me, man.
Where's the workshop?
Her workshop. She lives in.
Because that's probably where we're gonna end up.
I think she lives in West City.
Yeah, we do need to like get back because we have the recipe, so we need to turn it in.
Yes.
It's for Coca-Cola.
Secret Coca-Cola recipe.
Yeah.
You have it right.
That makes sense.
New Coca-Cola.
Oh, I've
that's
got it.
Fake out.
Okay. Shit, I didn't write down where she lives, but I think she lives in Lake City, which is across the lake. Okay. But you can find something on the east side.
So we're going east.
You're going east.
Go east. We're gonna just
the further east you go, the crazier it gets until you're literally in Indian country, and roads stop existing. So
fantastic.
West brings you back into the city.
Okay. Yeah, but we need to go. We have to end up going to the shop. We have to like recollect, and then we need to get this recipe.
Well, give me a roll, and we'll see. We'll see if you find somewhere suitable.
Fine. You are not.
Chad, so everyone knows we're operating without a dice cam. You're just gonna have to trust us.
Yeah,
all of these rolls.
Oh, 11 successes.
Three.
On 8 dice!
That was amazing!
It's a Valentine's miracle!
Some of them are still spinning in the air!
What do you got?
3
hits. That's good enough. Okay, cool. So yeah, you know there's a little place if you go up on the Woodenville Duval Road. There's sort of a parking structure that would fit your needs quite nicely. It's an old YMCA. It's kind of bombed out and destroyed, but the parking structure is still there.
Perfect.
And it's very low profile. So, all right, pull in. pull in, and Gidget is going to attempt to make the switch. She's going to give me an automatic...
What was that?
Automotive mechanic roll. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Should I drop the sass tonight? You are not.
No, please give me all the sass. And I'll try not to spit on you again.
That was real close.
Yeah, that was really bad. I don't know what is with me. I'm not even chewing gum tonight. Okay, and she gets.
You can salivate without chewing gum.
Really?
Yeah. What?
I know, science.
Spit take. Okay, so she gets 4 hits.
You know.
Great.
She goes out. She sort of expertly. She knew this is what it was. She can't quite reach the little high things because she's a little dwarf. So it's kind of cute. She has to get a little step stool out, she's just like, she's like,
okay, all right, that's fine.
And she's got it. She's got a little reach and stick. You know,
no
like
one touches my soccer van, but me.
And you guys have effectively changed everything about it. And she throws it in the back, and
hop back in, I guess.
Ready to hop back on the road. Okay, cool. Where to now?
Back to the workshop.
Okay.
When's our rendezvous?
Yeah, I was going to say, I do apologize, but it's been quite some time, so I don't remember exactly when our rendezvous is.
Rendezvous...
With the Johnson?
It needs to be set up. You haven't set it up yet.
Okay.
So let's go recollect. We just had quite a mission.
Mm-hmm. Let's drop this death van off. The van of doom.
Van full of death and doom. Evil robots. Okay.
Because Coca-Cola has a lot of sugar.
How many grams?
Hey, at least it's not corn syrup.
216.
What?
I don't know how big the batch is supposed to be.
Let's move on.
Let's
move on.
The other numbers are like 18 and 29, though.
Give me this.
Oh yeah, that was, by the way, that was the MacGuffin that they were recovering, was the, it is the secret recipe to Coca-Cola. Mm-hmm. So.
Now it's ours.
All right, well it
is
takes
this,
you.
Is this new Coke, new Coke, new classic Coke, classic new Coke?
Original.
I was about
classic.
To say, yeah.
Original cocaine Coke.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I think I saw it. There's coca in it, so.
Yeah.
Oh, it does have coca?
Nice. You know, a lot of coca. We're so far in the future that they probably
it's like sugar number one, coca number two.
Yes. New Coke.
It's like almost as much Coke as sugar.
New old Coke.
That's,
all right, those we're getting off
days,
track.
Man.
Yeah, all right, so you guys make your way back to Gidget's domicile, and she has got a garage, and you pull into the garage, and everything is as you left it. You've got the recipe in your hand, and...
I can call the Johnson.
You've made it back home. Safe and sound. Nobody the wiser.
Should we double check that we weren't followed?
How? What? Yeah. It couldn't hurt, that's for sure.
You just give me a intuition roll. It was just an intuition minus one.
Four.
See if you can confirm your suspicions. Actually, I think there's a, looks like a sense. Anyway, just give me an intuition roll.
On the way back, can I check astrally, make sure that we're not being followed by maybe another spirit that was summoned by the mage we had to put down?
Yeah, absolutely. You can do that. Yeah, you fly around and
into Henry's bush.
You don't see anything anything tracking you. I think all of the mages that could have done that were pretty full of bullet holes.
Yeah, we killed everyone.
Might have been a bound spirit that had, you know, an additional long service.
Hey!
Dude,
right.
Portly!
I love it!
Jordan Pritchin.
Right. What's that?
That's a good one.
That's Jordan Pritchin.
Hey,
Jordan! Hey,
Dirk Portly.
All right, thank you for subscribing. 3 months.
And thank you, the Bard 1971, for a mysterious donation.
For a mysterious donation.
It is a good for us.
How exciting!
Ooh.
All right, so yeah,
maybe
you guys.
You
do not
so
see any spirits following, and I will just save you a roll. You can buy these hits, which is a mechanic that you can change in. I think it's 3 dice to purchase 1 hit.
I don't know.
Okay, yeah, I need to look that up again.
I mean, that those would be the odds.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So if you buy a hit, you change in 3 dice to get 1 hit. And so I'm assuming you have at least a 3 in intuition. What's your intuition?
Intuition was 5.
Okay, 5.
But
does
danger sense not help with that?
Oh, danger sense is good. You actually have danger sense.
I do.
Give me a roll on that then.
Okay, and that's what I was just reading.
Where was that when the run began?
Oh, you have danger sense. That's one of your abilities, right?
I am getting to know Ketu more and more.
Chat, if you have never picked up Shadowrun 5th edition or any of the other editions, characters are very complicated, and there's a lot of little moving parts. So again, please forgive us if we make little mistakes, if we forget things about our character.
Also,
we're all learning this too.
I've never played ongoing RPG. That is part of my problem.
It's part of her charm.
Oh, that's charm. Cool. Charm is better than
I think it's more Shadowrun than you.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
But,
oh, you know how to swim? Flee! You'll figure it out.
No floaties.
No, sure. Move your arms more.
Here, let's light the water on fire somehow.
Oh my God. So for each level of this power, I get +1 die on surprise test. What's
a surprise test? Oh, a surprise test is something that I just did a video on.
Oh.
But that is a test that you make. To avoid being surprised by people, or to surprise people.
Do we have a link to that video?
I haven't finished it yet.
Oh,
I just watched the one you made and posted in our chat.
Mm-hmm.
That was great.
Thank you.
I'm sorry we weren't listening and just throwing cold fish.
I forgive you completely.
But I really like that you added in that.
Yeah. Yeah, it was a good throw. It was an amazing throw. You probably didn't watch it. I caught it when
it was up there.
It was great.
Makayla threw a goldfish into your mouth.
Oh,
yeah.
We're pretty awesome.
You got it.
You guys are pretty awesome.
We're coordinated.
So just roll 4 dice,
all right.
And then I'm going to tell you that nobody's following you.
That's 2 successes.
Two successes.
You're certain no one is following you.
just see here real quick.
You don't think anyone's following you, said the GM.
Nobody is following you, and you are pretty sure because you know these things.
I do.
You're dangerous. Mm. Okay. So, yeah, you get back and you've checked astrally, you have checked physically, you don't exist yet.
Yes.
And you.
I checked how much sugar is in this Coke, and it's a lot.
It's a lot. This is like a full day's worth of intake.
This is the America's youth. No wonder.
I should have played a dentist.
Yes, they do need a dentist. So you're back. You're in. You're in Gidget's kind of.
Oh, it should be Cocobites.
You're in Gidget's weird robot-y apartment, and you've got this thing. What are you doing? You have this, right?
The recipe? Yeah, I've got it.
Where did you put it?
Oh, I pocketed it. I put it in my secret
body pouch. In one of Dumas' holes?
Yeah. I put it in my flesh pouch.
One of your gross skin holes.
No. You're such a brosupial, man.
Brosupial?
That's true.
Oh, God.
Safely stowed in my body.
Okay, cool. You're back, and you've got the Johnson's number if you need it, or if you want to do some more
stuff. Listen, I'm not saying that this guy isn't on the level, but I'd feel a lot better if we had a safety policy and don't just show up with the recipe ready to hand it over in case he has a gang of people ready to jump us.
You know, I've had a bad feeling about this the whole time. Let's just get this done as soon as possible. Hmm.
Yeah, I mean, there was another group. We don't even know where they came from. How did they have the information that we had? Kind of makes me suspicious as well.
Yeah, maybe we should have asked them.
That orc definitely wanted him to open up the safe, so he knew what he was going for.
Yeah, maybe we should have this meeting. Yes. Even if we do this meeting to set up another meeting, he could jump us either place. But at least not to have it on us or something.
We don't all have to meet him. We don't all have to be there to meet him. Like, I can go and scout. Mm-hmm. And
does anyone have a contact? And maybe we can do a quick little, offer someone a little bit of a holding fee to just go somewhere who's not associated with this, hold on to the envelope.
What I was going to suggest. Oh.
Mm-hmm. Great minds.
Let's see.
Face?
I've got some contacts.
Chat, that absolutely was not a meta to get our fourth player in the game really quickly.
I just like listening to you guys. Go on.
I'm sorry, Chris.
It's fine. It's how this works. It's totally okay.
Maybe I could get a hold of old Dimitri. He's a smuggler. He might be fine with holding on to this for us while we...
Is he trustworthy?
Trustworthy is not the word for this fellow.
Once bought, will he stay bought?
I have a street dog.
Yeah, unless somebody buys him for a lot higher. He's fairly...
You don't sound very certain. What about...
Maybe one of us should just hold on to it and stay aside from the rest of us.
I'm just concerned that if he has a hidden force that's going to ambush us, that the more of us that are there... as a show of force, may either head that off or be able to get out. So if we divide our forces,
how
many of us met with him the first time?
Well, he doesn't have to know what he has.
I think everyone but Grabsy.
Yeah, Grabsy was in the car.
Papa Chops was there.
Yeah. Yeah. Ludo's new.
Hey!
Thank you, Carlos Cubstar. Carlos Cubstar.
Thank you for the follow.
For following. You're my favorite person, Carlos.
You know who we can trust? Who probably doesn't have anything better to do because they're just looking up recipes all the time. We just let it sit with Grabsy in the car.
Maybe.
Yeah, sure. I can do that for you. Why am I holding the recipe? Are we going to give it to the Mr. Johnson?
After we check out the situation, make sure that we're going
to get. That's kind of exactly what I want to avoid. Yeah, because if we're just telling them to come out to the van.
No, I don't want them to come out to the van. We're going to leave Grabsy behind.
We might, if we do get ambushed, though, we'll need his skills to help us, probably. I mean, that was to be, like, the show of force, right?
So I really was trying to just do, like, a metagame that one of us knew him. But
oh, yeah, no, I have plans for him.
Oh, you do? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, I mean, that's fine.
I didn't know if you knew how you were going to introduce
you.
I was just trying to.
I appreciate it.
I know, you're a gentleman.
Thank you.
You're a scholar, a gentleman, but yeah, we're going to get to him very soon. So you just want to leave the recipe with Grabsy then?
Let's see.
I mean, what are our real options here?
I just think it might be best if the three of us go, we can leave the recipe with Ketu, who can conceal himself, and then, you know, when the time is right, we can call him forth. And,
that's true. I'm not much of a people person.
There'll still be three of us. That's still a pretty significant show for us. Anything else would be pretty conspicuous, I feel like, actually.
Okay, cool.
Does that sound all right?
Yeah, let's do it.
A little bit of housekeeping here. We'll start with the Bard 1971. Mysterious Bard 1971 gives Ooh. Nick a sploosh.
Woo!
And moreover, it's a hit!
Oh, yeah!
You get a sploosh and a hit, young man.
Yes, thank you. Okay, so two different
yes.
icons
here. One of those is a sploosh.
One of them is a hit. Secondly,
well, they should.
Thank you.
Our good friend Dirk Portley gives me, your humble narrator, a free reroll.
Oh, no.
Tink, 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 tink. Mm. Thank you very much, Mr. De Portley.
Contract requires that we thank you.
I'm going to use that for a character that I have who's going to be visiting us, hopefully this session, but probably next session. Last but not least, Selden Arceus gives Makayla his free sub reroll.
Nice.
Ooh,
nice catch.
Thank you.
So, Makayla, you get a reroll from Selden Arceus. Thank you, Selden Arceus.
You were quick. I didn't realize that you had your hands under there. I wouldn't have
blown Yeah, man.
Physical adept.
Yeah. Cat-like reflexes.
Can't even help.
Ketu-like fleet reflexes.
Oh.
I mean, I could go for that.
The goldfish have entered the room.
But I just have to inject myself in any conversation involving goldfish.
Oh, sure. Thank you.
So you guys got a plan, but Dunson still has no idea that you have the recipe.
That's fine.
You can share my cup, bro.
Two beards, one cup?
Yeah, I was...
Oh, my God. I laughed, and then I realized...
How old are you?
I don't know.
This many. Probably.
I can get you a cup.
I'm good. Actually, but I appreciate you.
I am not Valentine's the oldest one at the table.
I am not sharing a really cup with anyone.
Happy Valentine's Day from Saving Throw to you.
Love you guys.
That's gonna be a gift,
Ow!
And a little heart is gonna go. It's gonna be really neat.
In post.
Yes, in post.
Yeah. In post, yeah.
Someone just Snapchats it. I'm good, thank you.
Slap a filter on it.
Yes. Okay, so yeah, cool, you guys have a plan. And you still have a recipe, and you have a Johnson who wants it.
I'm gonna call that Mamma Jamma.
The recipe, wants the recipe.
Do you call him?
Yep.
I got it.
Okay.
He lets it ring. Twice.
Ooh. A power play.
Oh. And he picks up. Talk to me.
Well, howdy, Johnson. I think we've got something you're looking for.
You got it?
Maybe.
Oh, great. Good. Perfect. This is fantastic. How soon can you meet?
I can probably pretty soon. What are you thinking?
Yeah, can you meet in 20 minutes?
20 minutes?
20 minutes at the Gooey Duck?
You just have that much money on you?
Let's, it's, what do you say, 20 minutes?
20 minutes sounds good. I just wanted to ask you, though, about a strange occurrence that happened. It kind of seemed like we weren't the only ones there. You know anything about that?
I mean, yeah, there was a family there.
Right? No, we weren't the only Shadow Runners there.
Oh.
Since you had the information about, you know, everything that was happening, I thought maybe you'd know something about that, huh?
God damn it. It was probably a miscommunication. Fuck.
Double booked.
All right. You know what? No, it's it's fine. I got a couple phone calls to make. Tell you what, can we do this? I'm gonna say it's 7:30 about now. By the time you get all this stuff done, let's say 8 o'clock because you had to go. Can you meet me at 10 o'clock?
Yeah.
You got 2 hours?
I sure can.
Okay, good. I gotta make a couple of phone calls.
As long as I don't see any more Shadow Runners.
You know me, man. That was this kind of stuff happens. So, fuck me.
Huh?
All right, I got okay. Okay, 10 o'clock.
All right.
He's so green. all right.
It's always nice to work with professionals.
So So the only problem with that is those other Shadowrunners are all dead.
That's what they get.
When he makes those phone calls, though, he's going to find out.
Do you guys want to do anything in the next 2 hours?
I don't see a problem. The Shadowrunners weren't included in the contract.
Yeah, and he's going to know better, hopefully, for next time.
Why don't we just recharge?
This is the kind of, this is like a, what do you call this? It's a lesson, like a teaching moment. Teachable moment.
Teachable moment.
Oh, my whole other team of Shadowrunners died because I mixed up and double booked.
Oh, oops.
Yeah, can you do your best Gidget impression?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I don't remember what she sounds like. What does Gidget sound like?
You know,
the
like
way
Kelsey.
That she always does.
Oh, yeah, totally. What would you like?
All right, no, you're doing that. That sounds exactly like.
Great. Are you EQing me? Dom is doing a killer job on the EQ.
Thank you for the EQs, Dom, and thank you, chat, and thank you.
Oh my God! What?
I don't know.
How many pages?
I know it's ridiculous.
Yeah, it's actually the full one's 34 pages. That's the truncated version. Kelsey wanted to play a rigger. Do you guys want to do anything in the next 2 hours?
Oh, I do.
That was sad.
I do.
It was
I'm embarrassed.
You could be right out of the corner.
I know. That was my fault. That was me.
Okay. I want to summon a spirit.
The drums.
Summon a spirit.
Yes. Because I want to do this right.
Okay.
You know, I want to kick this off the right way.
Doing
this
by the book. Yeah. Tyler's not going to make a video out of this one.
Let's hope not.
Hell no.
Watcher, no. I'm going to summon a spirit. Watchers take hours at a lodge and all sorts of magical power.
Yes.
Why would I do something like that?
Okay. Summon me a spirit, man.
Okay.
What kind of spirit would you like to summon?
I'm going to see if they're... Well, I think that what happens is I have to sort of see what's available in the area.
Okay.
My preference would be a water spirit, since in my tradition those are the spirits of detection.
Okay. Hmm.
You can only choose a type of spirit available to your tradition. Most traditions have 5 types. You also need to choose the spirit's force. The higher the force, the more powerful the spirit.
Okay.
Up to twice your magic rating.
Ah, I see you here. Okay, cool. So, you're going to try to summon a water spirit? I think that's available to your tradition.
It is.
Yeah, okay. Do that. What force would you like this water spirit to be?
I am going to...
Spirit of water.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I will try, I think, a... You know, I'm mainly looking just for detection, so just like a Force 3 spirit.
Okay.
Something simple.
Okay, cool.
And something that I think I can handle since I probably haven't had the downtime for stun yet.
Right. Yes. Okay, so he makes an opposed test, which is his Force. You probably don't have any regents, yeah?
No.
Okay, cool.
Not as such.
Okay, so summoning plus magic with Force as the limit.
Summoning 8 dice for me.
8 dice, okay.
And have I had any chance to rest and recover from stun, or am I still down the whole shebang?
You're still down a little bit.
Okay. Oh, speaking of, what is everyone happening?
Oh yeah.
I know, Chris.
Yeah,
I'm fresh as a daisy.
Everybody's fresh as a daisy except
Dom, I am at 9 of 10 physical damage, and I am at, I didn't realize I was still this zonked, or I might not have done this. I am at 3 of 11 stun.
So, Dom, from both Dirk Portley and Seldon Arceus, could you give me 2 names from each of them? Are they still around?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that all right?
2 names each?
Yeah. Are you okay with it? What? Thanks, Dom. You're a peach.
Yo, peach.
Two names for 2 subs. Okay, cool. So let's make a roll, brother.
All right.
Show me what you got.
What I got is not very good right now.
Show me what you got. Oh, holy shit.
Oh, I'm sorry. I wanted to add my sploosh here.
Okay.
Which was still not a success.
Oh my God.
I have one success.
You have one success. Jesse, can you peek your head over here and just confirm this for me?
Probably. Yeah, what is the airplane sound?
That's Revlo, that's our XP.
Yep.
Someone donate something.
I'm about to get knocked out right now.
Yeah, so.
Couple of sixes.
I rolled two hits. You got nothing else? No more splooshes?
You have it. It's a hit. Right?
You have an it's a hit?
Yeah, I guess I'll burn it. Right. I'll burn all my stuff.
What happens if you fail? Does that mean the spirit wins? Is that what's up?
Well, I'm not exactly sure.
If you get no net hits, the spirit doesn't show up.
Right.
If you get net hits, the spirit arrives.
Oh, so that doesn't help me, because if you have two and I only have one, I'd have no net hits. I'm still zero. Oh, right.
Correct.
So okay. I'm going to pretend that we...
Pretend that didn't happen.
So I try and summon a spirit. Nothing's available.
You just go...
I reach out, and there's no...
Spirit, come to me!
It's probably more like orc slam techno bands that he uses as the beat.
For example.
Yeah. Since he's right into... Really?
Yeah. You set yourself up.
Yeah, I should have learned. I want my spirit right now. I will come prepared next time if this is the challenge.
Cool. But it doesn't happen.
But I still have to resist drain.
The spirits go.
Yeah, there's just nothing available that meets my needs.
Yep. So drain is
twice the hit. So you got two hits.
I got two hits.
So my drain value is four.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So four, and I need to resist off of 10 dice.
Pretty good. Oh God.
I got it here. 10 dice, and we said that and I still have to subtract 3 from my stun damage.
No. What's your stun damage? You're just minus 1, right?
No, I'm minus 3.
You're minus 3. Oh, really?
Oh, I'm actually at minus 4 because I have a box of physical damage.
Oh my God. Yeah. Holy shit. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, there's a good chance I'm going to knock myself out here, guys.
Well, we'll put you on a...
Well, that's okay.
Knock yourself out.
There's enough time. There's enough time for me to get a recovery roll.
Yes, I prefer... You're going to be out for 2 hours.
That's why I did it first.
So, yeah. Okay.
Nick! Looks like a success.
You're killing me here, man.
How many did you need?
So you take 3 points.
I needed... Four.
Yeah, you take three points of stun damage.
Ooh. Which puts you...
Which drops me.
Out. Would your it's a hit have saved you?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I didn't spend it there because I also looked up the recovery rules.
Cool. Great.
It's
like
so,
an hour, right?
Guys,
yeah, that's
the orc starts doing some really, really weird shit that he's never done before.
Like
you've never seen him
head do before. Headbanging and like slam dancing by himself, like in a circle.
He is mad, and you don't know what he is doing. And he falls unconscious.
Well, I told them.
Yes, he told you what he was doing.
They have all worked with me before. They know that I would...
Have you ever summoned a spirit before? Because...
Of course I have. In the past, before the game started.
When no one was looking.
Right. Retcon. Right.
Yeah, he gets knocked out. Oh. And as soon as he gets knocked out, you hear a voice from the heavens that says, "The Dark Lord Nani Marco gives the table, and it's a hit!"
Hey!
On top of that, Gurnal Fancy Pants, General Fancy Pants.
Ooh.
General.
Because GNRL stands for General.
Fancy.
Gives Moonbiter a med pack to heal one stun.
Hey!
Hey.
You have to use it, right?
Yes, you've got to use it. So, how that works is.
So immediately, he starts to fall, whips out a needle, jams himself in the arm.
It is 6 dice. Every hit heals you 1 point of damage.
Okay.
Seldon Arceus has given me something. Oh boy.
Are you able to since you're knocked out?
I think we're saying that I could do it right as I was.
Oh, now you get him.
Now I got him.
Yes. He falls on a needle that's just kind of casually laying around.
Everyone thought it was decoration, but I have these needles sticking out of my orc jacket that are actually all full of med packs.
Yeah.
The poor man's auto injector.
That's right.
Brilliant.
So, brilliant.
There we go.
Yes, just he collapses in a noisy heap. Goes boom, boom. I'm okay. What happened?
Like one of those inflatable clown things.
Yes, exactly. Oh. Oh. He wobbles. Right.
Enjoy
but
the
he
nightmares,
does not
everybody.
Fall down.
Yeah. Let's have a sit down. Come on. Let's go have a sit down.
Okay. Plus willpower. Extended test.
Okay. So that happens. You guys.
I'm gonna try to. Oh, buddy, come on. Let's go sit down.
There's no spirits in the area for me to summon, but let me I'm gonna meditate and see if I can get back in the game.
Okay, just be careful.
Tyler, do we still have we're only gonna have like 1 hour because then we're gonna have to get in the truck and get to the meet.
Right.
So it's a 2 hour.
It's about it's gonna be about an hour to drive there, yeah, from where you are. You're in Lake City, you gotta get across to Redmond.
Okay, so according to page 207, for those of you following along at home,
that's about
stun damage can be healed by
a
body plus willpower, 1 hour extended test. The character must rest for the entire hour for it to count. Forced naps and unconsciousness also count. So that's why I was knocking myself great.
All right.
Each hit heals one box of stun damage.
Okay.
Now,
cool.
Now, I am assuming that because it doesn't make much sense otherwise, but I'm assuming that the recovery rolls don't have, like I'm not at minus dice on that. Because otherwise it's this horrible loop of whenever you got hurt, you wouldn't be able to heal from getting hurt.
You are correct.
Which is often actually kind of true.
Okay, I got you, Sylvan, Arceus, thank you.
Hence and the gravity needles.
That first guy.
That's the gravity needles.
That first guy you put in there, it's the leader. So good job getting that in first. Much love.
Happy I hope Valentine's he doesn't Day. Have a strong name.
Blowing kisses to everyone.
It's Valentine's Day.
Can we all do it?
Yeah.
Oh, that's at least three.
What's
that over there? So that's what's that? Three.
So I'm just making fun
of him. So Moonbiter goes into a kind of meditative trance for that hour. sort of chanting to himself.
Okay.
sounds like it might be lyrics from orc bands, but it's in Orzhet, so I don't know if anyone speaks Orzhet.
Nope.
I mean, Grabzy would.
Grabzy does.
Probably.
Grabzy hates that stuff.
Oh, wow.
He listens to classic rock.
Right.
You know,
right.
Arcade Fire.
Yeah.
Arcade Fire.
Mumford and Sons. Classic. The classicest rock.
Yeah.
I'm in the bathroom getting hot.
Neo.
Stained.
Stained.
Oh, no.
Oh, well, that's grandpa music. Stained? Are you kidding me?
All right, so that gets me three more boxes.
Okay.
Putting me only to the minus two, so I'm five down now.
Five down now. Are you guys ready to head out to this meet, finally, for Christ's sake?
We still have an hour.
You mean you're at six?
And you can rest in the car, too, right?
Yeah.
Like, you can meditate in
yes.
the car.
Yes. Yeah,
I'm
you still got an hour.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Do you guys want to do anything for this?
Do you want to go scout the location? Just see if anything.
We should probably go a little early.
Go watch for a bit.
All right.
Do a little perimeter.
Like yeah, if you want to do that, and then I can catch up on the, I can hop on my motorcycle and head out afterwards.
I'd like to think that while Grabs is driving, that I have swiped his phone, I'm looking through
the... Oh, Grabs doesn't drive.
I don't have my license. I've never driven a car before.
Oh, it's always...
Yep.
Oh, that's true.
Don't forget the mom
still
thing.
Still does.
Yep.
I love Grabsy so much. I follow Grabsy on Twitter and he delights me.
Yeah, I know. Grabsy's delights me. It's so much fun.
Yeah. All right, well, he's not driving. I just do it when he's not paying attention. This is... steal his phone and start looking at the recipes and start going.
Give me a, what is that called? It's like a sleight of hand or something.
I have it.
Palming?
Palming. That's the
seven.
One.
Seven.
Okay.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. Give me a palming roll. And I will give you I believe it's, hold on, a little.
Palming Grabsy. How ironic.
You're gonna steal poor Grabsy's phone?
Yeah.
What did he ever do to you?
I want to see what these recipes are. If I start liking some of them.
There's plural? Plural recipes?
Oh, so nothing to do with the recipes.
Oh, I see.
When he was looking up the family before, he was talking about the wife.
Uh-huh.
He's like, and she has a lot of good recipes. And
I
went
this.
On about
that's
it
right,
for
that's
a
right.
while.
On future like, Pinterest.
And I was so infuriated because he was supposed to be doing his job and they like found out useless information. Yeah. Well, I
it's
guess
only
it,
from
it
the
could
bougie
be.
People,
it could
so it's called
be.
Sintress.
Oh, okay. Nice.
All right,
so he gets, seven dice.
Oh. Well, I could be worse.
I only got two.
Jesse, can you take a look at this just to verify?
Oh, my goodness. That's a big old four. It's a four successes.
So, So you reach for his phone, grabs it, goes, what are you doing? do you need to use my phone?
I do.
Okay, here.
Thanks.
I can just hop on the internet. I don't really even need a comm link. Most of my information is stored on my CyberDAC.
So if I go in your history, it's going to be...
Oh, that's just a burner phone. Oh, yeah, like I use a comm link. like I got him a scrub. That's very funny. But if you need to make a call, I mean, I don't have a lot of contacts, but, you know, feel free to kind of root around or you just want to browse the Matrix for a while. That's fine, too. I'm going to go into VR mode.
I love him so much.
Yeah, dude, he's the best.
I want him to have his own show.
He does.
The Grabsy Hour.
You're all here to just support Grabsy.
All right. So yeah, but you managed to find her Pinterest. Because he sends the bookmark to you. Because it seems like you might be interested. You browse around. That's really good. A lot of Asian fusion kind of recipes. Seems like a very nice woman. This is the one you knocked unconscious.
I did not knock her unconscious. My team did.
Yeah, you just knocked your son unconscious. That's
right, true. I did that.
Yes.
All right.
I was pretending to type a URL into her pad.
That's right.
I was like, oh, let me get that for you.
Anybody else? Anything for the last hour? Going once? Going twice?
I'm gonna ask the table real quick, just on quick meta. I'm thinking about hitting myself with a heal real quick before I go, because the test is, I only need to heal one box. I can get 12 dice with only a 2 drain resist, and I'm pretty sure I can hit 2 successes. But it would, so like from a strategy standpoint, it would drop me 1 fewer boxes of penalty, so I'd be a lot more useful.
What's the downside?
The downside is if I can't soak 2 drain, then I'm right back where I started before I took an hour to heal.
Do it. Right. What's the future equivalent of YOLO?
Chris, why did I
invite you?
You only win once.
You're crazy.
Only
live you out your mind.
I didn't mean that. Stop it.
I know, I love that. It's the grossest sounding.
It's
way
so,
express.
It's, yeah.
It's lovely.
Sheldon's
going to
get
okay. So I'm going to go ahead and, before I hop on the bike, just do a quick heal on myself to take care of that physical damage.
All right, man.
Whoa.
And as long as I get a success, I'm fine. And I got at least, I got 4 here, nice. So okay. I got plenty. And then let me roll my drain test real quick.
What was the force of that heal spell?
6.
6. Serious business, man.
Yeah. Well, because anything less than that is exactly the same amount of drain, so I might as well hit it at 6.
Force minus 4, yeah.
Right.
So you get 2 boxes to resist that drain?
Yeah.
Or two hits of drain to resist?
Yeah, I have 2 hits of drain to resist. And we said, again, that is going to be 10 is my resist.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm going to be minus the stun damage. So I'm minus 2 dice.
Minus 2, yeah. Okay. You might want to look into purchasing some things to help you with that, with the money that you got coming to you.
Yeah, most of mine are combat oriented, so I might do a heal. I don't think I have a healing one.
Something to help you with brain. I believe there's a talisman that you can get to.
Yeah, I just don't think I have a healing foci.
Oh, yeah, right. Okay. All right, cool. So give me your drain roll, brother.
Yeah. Sorry. So we can move ahead.
Yes. Drain roll, brother.
I see at least 2 successes there.
Yeah.
3, 4.
You get it.
So
yeah. You do it.
All right.
Great.
Lovely.
It's good to get it out. These feelings inside.
These feelings. Okay.
They can only be expressed through Orzet rock.
That's right.
Orzet, the Orzettiest. Okay, so who is going to
it
go?
It works great for hangovers too.
Who is going to go scout
There's
out the Guida?
Not a chance. That's true.
I'll scout.
You're going to scout?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay, how are you getting there?
Alcohol poisoning would be physical damage.
I assumed we were going together.
Yeah, let's park like a few blocks away.
I think you're
going to drive in his in his car.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you meant the Orzet.
Maybe you can drive my car.
That's what I meant.
Who has the recipe? Do you have the recipe?
No.
I've got it. As soon as she's done scouting and comes back, when I go in for the meeting, I'm going to give it to her.
Okay, cool. Yeah. All right.
Nick, what did you heal?
I healed 1 point of physical damage, so I should be full now.
Firecrackers.
Firecrackers. It's our favorite new follower. Mm. Oh, wait, Cracker 5. Firecracker 5.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
It looks like it is.
Okay, so who is heading over to the Gooey Duck? You, just you.
Nah, I mean, I might as well take a look around, too. We might as well all kind of sweep.
Okay. But,
well, I do have the recipe, though.
Well, I thought you guys were heading out an hour earlier while I did my chanting and recovery. And then I'll join you for the meeting.
Yeah, why don't we send some drones around, then, to just, like, take a
look. Oh, yeah, we don't have Gidget to...
Oh, is she not coming?
We do have Gidget.
We do. I'm just saying that we forget.
And I've memorized her sheet, so it's super easy. You tell me what you want done, and I'll...
Yeah, which drones are you going to send out?
Page 2 through 55.
Fly drone and fly drone.
Yeah, and the armored drones. Yeah. And
No. Probably like the eye and the fly spy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like usual.
Yeah. You know, what I do.
Yeah. Typical Gidget.
I know. Classic Gidget.
Classic. Okay, cool. Yeah. So, I mean, are you guys just all going to go? I mean, or are you just going to leave the orc behind?
I'm not going to go.
You're not going to go?
I'm going to... Well, you're not... Are you there yet?
Doing?
You're not there yet, right? I'm going to stay with the band and grab
you.
Are
you
going to
sit on your ass?
I'm valuable property in my skin pouch.
Gross! Gross!
So it smells like just the cleanest car, the newest car. In
there. Ugh. Oh, God. He just sticks one of those pine saws.
Yeah, the trees.
Not too chemically, but still fresh.
So my understanding was this, is that while I'm back there meditating, you guys were going to go and, you know, do some recon.
Right.
And then we'd all meet up and then go into the meeting.
Yes. Except for Ketu, who's going to stay...
Right. Stay hidden with the... With the recipe in case it's double cross.
Indeed.
Okay. Cool. So, people who go to the Gooey Duck, you head over there, park several blocks away, walk up. It's the same disgusting Gooey Duck that it was, except it's nighttime now. So it's a little busier, you know? Mm. There's kind of I want to say there's a line out the door, but you can hear, you know, the music coming from inside. They crank it up. It's not quite 10 o'clock a.m. Gooey Duck. This is 10 o'clock p.m. Gooey Duck. This is when shit really gets exciting.
This is prom Gooey Duck.
Yeah, yeah. They get the hottest girls dancing on the Gooey Duck stage. And the slickest bartenders.
No brunch specials.
That Nguyen can afford. Mm. So, the building's there. What are you looking for?
Danger sense?
Danger sense? It was
Hint.
It was called
Danger Sense.
Danger Sense. Last time I entered through the roof.
Out through the roof.
Yeah, wherever else went in the front. And so, if there's a line out the door, maybe there's a way I could find.
Oh yeah.
Another way in.
I don't want to have to wait in line. Well, the Johnsons might be already meeting there by the time we are ready to actually go in. So.
You think he's there an hour early?
Not yet, no.
Yeah.
I mean, we probably can't get in yet, but we can definitely do above and maybe.
I just kind of want to do a scouting to see if there's anything too suspicious.
Any people just like staring out windows like, where are these guys coming?
Yeah, this is going to be the best ambush ever, right? I can't wait.
I bet you Coca-Cola's really healthy.
I don't know, I heard it has a lot of sugar.
Let me hop on the Twitter and say, hey guys, best ambush, hashtag best ambush ever. Send.
Oh man.
Love my job.
They'll never see this coming.
With like the sign in the background glowing.
Okay, so what do you do specifically then, Makayla?
I wanted to just kind of scout around the building to see if there's anything.
Okay.
I think it would be too time consuming to try to go in and really look around.
Okay. So you just kind of go around the circumference of the building.
Mm-hmm.
You don't see anything. You know, you're kind of looking up in windows. Give me a perception roll.
Sure. Perception 8. Three
hits. Yeah. You're relatively confident. This is not a great neighborhood, but there don't seem to be any street toughs. You're a very street savvy, street wise person. you know, yeah, you don't see any obvious signs of an ambush in the physical world.
Oh, that's right, in the physical world. Okay. I'm glad that you put that in there.
Well, that's all you can really perceive is the physical world.
So. It's true.
In our line of work, right. Things are not always as they seem.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Roll for
We're
it.
We're going
to
be fine.
Do for, you, though.
Roll for bad feelings.
Yeah. Everything's going to be fine.
Hey,
this
hey,
is Shadowrun.
This isn't never tell me the odds. This is Shadowrun. That's a copyrighted phrase.
Sorry.
Okay. Jesse, what are you going to do?
I'm in the car, just waiting for the all clear.
Getting on his ass. Time.
Yeah, just chilling.
Okay.
Just,
I'm sorry. Real quick, what is this picture of Dom on the wall? What is going on?
That is the founder of the RPG Exploration Society, coming soon to a Twitch channel near you.
Mm-hmm. That.
This one.
Yeah.
That's not me.
What?
That's not me.
Yeah. That's Sir Reginald Zookington.
No.
No.
That's Lord Domwell Zookington.
Domwell.
Oh, yes. I hope you all speak like that with horrible South African accents.
So good, yes. Chef.
I will be running my entire adventure at this accent.
I think you quite enjoy playing mutants and masterminds with this accent.
Can you make your mustache thicker?
Roll for pizza.
Mutton chops. Yeah. Everything. Just all of it. Can you please?
I mean, it's a great photo.
It is.
Yeah.
It is a fantastic
solid
photo.
Work. So you're staying in the car, you don't see anything, an hour passes, and the van is ready to leave. Gidget and Grabsy are all loaded up. Are you coming?
Oh, so I'm heading out with them? Oh, because they didn't go for the recon. But no. Yes.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, you bet.
Guys, I'll load up in the van, you hop on I-5 going north. You get off at the Bothell Everett Highway.
I think
scoot across the Bothell Everett Highway, just north of north of Lake Washington.
Tyler, this isn't an episode of the Californians.
You get on 522.
You don't have to describe exactly how you got there.
You go to the 522 down to the 405, then hit south on the 405, exit on 160th, and you make your way over to the Glistening Gooey Duck.
I keep seeing pictures of those. I hate it.
I know.
And I think of all
I'm
of
here
you
to
guys.
Torment
yeah, man, they're,
you.
They're terrible.
With awful imagery.
Yeah!
Okay.
Children.
So yeah, it's a little after 10 o'clock now. And,
Oh, really?
What do you guys do?
We need to make our way into the club.
What's that?
We need to make our way into the club.
I'm gonna call and make sure he's there.
Good call.
Literally.
All right, so it's just a little after 10?
Yeah.
I'm gonna give him a call.
Okay. It rings three times.
Oh my God, this mother.
He's putting me on tilt.
Nuh-uh.
Nuh-uh.
And it's not how we do it.
Picks up. Just hello.
Hang up on it.
He's trying to talk over the music. Hello.
How's it looking? You in there?
Hello.
You in?
Yes.
Are you inside?
I'm inside.
Okay, I'll see you in a second.
Do you have?
You got a table?
What?
You have a table?
Hello, yes.
Okay.
I'm inside.
I heard that.
I can't talk right now.
Okay, goodbye.
Jesus Christ.
That was productive. Well, at least we know he's inside. Mission accomplished. All right.
Okay.
Care for you, John.
Who's going inside? Gidget's probably going to stay in the car.
And drop it on the car.
Gidget's going to stay in the car.
Yeah.
Because Gidget doesn't know how Gidget would act if Gidget were to enter
a
club.
Oh, God, all these people? All these meat sacks?
Yeah. She's got a little street slime on it.
Also,
she's already a little...
We know from last time there's a magnetic thing outside the front, and she doesn't want the bouncer to even look at her, so...
Where do you guys park the car? Do you park down the street? Do you park, like, in the neighborhood, or...
We should probably keep them close.
Yeah, close by.
So just park out front?
There's death drones in the van.
Not right out front.
I don't
I'm
think right
like
out front. I think
away.
Like half a block away.
Okay,
half
so like block. back in the neighborhood then with the
yeah. Because I think that we'd also like to have him not be that familiar with the vehicle we drive.
Got it.
Yeah,
that's good.
Okay. Sounds good. So you guys walk up to the Gooey Duck. Y'all gonna go inside? Who all's going inside? You? You? You go inside?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
I want to take a quick astral overwatch. Mm-hmm. Make sure that there's no magical entities that are keeping this under surveillance. I probably do that from the van as we pull up. So
okay,
just clap in the street. In the middle
bonk.
Of
the
stripper's like.
Is he okay?
That's actually the perfect use for the champagne room. Because you sit back, right. You don't touch anybody.
Yeah, right? Is he privacy? Even enjoying this? Really? I don't even
privacy.
Know.
Honest, keep that in mind. Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah, you go screaming around. Plenty of astral signatures of people, nothing that looks too crazy or magical. No spirits, you know. Okay. Everything is calm in the Barrens of Redmond.
All right.
Yeah, so it's all good. You descend into the club?
Yeah.
Into the club? All right. You descend the steps into the gooey duck.
Is it the same bouncer?
Same bouncer. Bomp. Bomp don't need no sleep.
So at least he knows us.
Yep.
Because I don't know this dude's name to say, hey, we've got a table with so-and-so.
Right.
Yeah.
So is there a line?
No.
Okay.
No.
Okay,
I know,
yeah.
That's a big spot.
That's right there.
That's like experiment rhino size.
We've been here before.
Yeah.
This is how it looked last time.
You walk in from here. Bump. 5 new yen to get in.
Oh.
No
cover
problem
charge.
At all, my good man. How expensive is new yen?
Huh?
Oh, I'm going to give him 10.
It gives you change. Thanks, but no thanks.
All right. I like your integrity, buddy.
Check your weapons at the door.
Can do.
Okay. You guys give over your weapons?
Absolutely.
That's true. You give over all your weapons.
Aren't you waiting outside with the...
I'm just hidden.
Oh, okay, cool.
Oh.
I think, like, before, I'm going to leave the street line in the...
That's right.
The street line
I'm not
the,
there.
We go back.
Okay.
Hidden.
Just kidding, Bob.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm just having a
no. It's all right.
Down here.
I'm gonna give you a roll here.
Just trying to find all my stuff.
See what happens. This is a
yeah. And how do I check against that again?
I make a test against the modifiers.
I'm sorry,
like,
I'm gonna stop throwing.
With a holdout, it's like -2, and it's a rating 3.
You're very good at that.
It's a rating 3 sensor. So I get 0 hits, so it's always seen on a very good machine. This place does not have top-of-the-line technology.
Okay.
You're able to get through, you get able to get your street lighting through. And same with Ketu and her little knives.
No, I believe Ketu is not,
yeah, she's not
entering
in, actually.
Oh, Ketu's not entering. She's going to be prowling around. Okay, cool. And so Ketu, you have the recipe?
I do.
Okay, cool. Good. So you give bump 10 new yen, 1-5 for each of you.
Okay.
Right? I mean, I'm assuming you're paying for him, right?
Yeah,
it's course. The polite thing to do. Yeah,
it's definitely, it's the move.
So, you guys walk into the gooey duck. It is bustling with activity. There are upwards of a dozen people in here.
Oh,
and two of the smoking hottest dancers that you have seen in this building compared to the other one that you've seen.
This place got way more gooey.
Yeah, it is. It still has that kind of
listless, like a 400% increase in the number of people
sad,
in this place.
Smelly feeling. But the dancers, they look a little more awake because it's not so early. And, you know, people are just kind of going about their business. What you do at a strip club? You go there to have fun, not be sad. Okay.
True.
Pretty depressing.
You see, you are Johnson.
You don't go there to be sad. That just happens organically.
Yes. Sitting right here.
So booze are for.
In this spot.
And we're coming in right here?
Yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Yep.
You walk up to him.
So where are the other patrons?
Oh God, scattered around. There's a dozen of them.
Okay.
I'm not gonna put little X's, but just imagine
all over the place.
Yeah, we got 4 guys at the bar, a couple of guys at a table. There's a bachelor party, probably. I mean, it's the saddest bachelor party ever because it's just 3 guys. One of them is crying.
You have Starfire right here.
Poor guy.
While getting a lap dance because he's thinking about his fiance.
He's a good man.
Yeah, he's a good man.
He's a good man.
He's a good man.
Whoa.
He didn't want the dance.
Whoa!
It's nice.
What do you think bachelor parties do at strip clubs?
Why is your eyebrow so twitchy?
I don't know. It's my Bell's palsy.
Oh.
But you know, but he's a good guy. He doesn't feel right about this. But at the same time, he doesn't want to be rude. His friend bought him the lap dance, so he's just.
That's bullshit, by the way. Oh, I don't want to be rude. Do what you need to do.
Maybe, make it quick. I'm going to be picturing my fiance the whole time.
It's possible he's just scouting the area with his spirit form. You never know.
That's true.
If we learned anything earlier.
Hashtag right? Spirit form half laughing.
All right, so as soon as we come up to this area, the first thing I'm going to do, after I've identified where he is see if anyone's looking at him anywhere else in the club.
No, nobody's looking at him at all.
Or if anyone's paying attention to people coming in.
Also true, yeah. No, nobody even looks your way.
Right.
They are focused. There is, it's getting
They
too
know the rules. No eye contact in the strip club. Or
sorry. The dance is building to a crescendo right here. She's still fully clothed at the moment.
Oh, that's the main stage.
Yeah, that's the main stage. Oh. That's where the hottest of the hot go.
The gooeyest of the gooey.
The gooeyest of the
I don't like this place.
I regretted it right when it came out.
Kidding, I didn't. She just got out there and she's ready. The song just started up. It's a classic from the 20th century, you know. She's my cherry pie.
Yeah.
Of course.
I knew it.
Of course it is.
That's just on repeat.
It's an interesting juxtaposition because it's so old that it's like classical music, and then she's, you know, being very...
Like, oh, she's so classy.
That's right. She's bringing her up a notch.
She's my gooey duck. What's the next line? What's the next line?
Something that rhymes with
that. We'll leave that for you to figure out.
Put the next line in the chat, folks.
Send us your best lyric.
So he is sitting there and he looks...
he's nervous. Well, if we don't see anybody, I'm going to sidle on over and sit across the table from him.
I feel like I should declare this before I wish I had declared it. Gidget, every round, is buying the maximum success that she can on a sensors check.
Okay.
Passive perception or whatever the car rigger thing is for it.
Yeah.
And I don't know what else she's capable of in terms of like monitoring and surveillance, but she's doing those on her other simple action every turn.
Okay. Cool. All right.
Yep.
Good to know.
Just excellent.
She's doing her job.
Yeah. Nice. Right. It's what Kelsey would do.
Yeah. Mm. Kelsey, yeah.
It's what Kelsey
every time.
Do.
I feel like I'm talking to Kelsey right now. It's the weirdest thing.
Indeed.
Okay, so you walk over, and he goes, and he looks up, and he goes, okay. Hey, guys.
Hey.
Have a seat.
Okay.
Sorry, have a seat. He's like, I have something that I saw on the 10 o'clock news just now.
Is this you?
Yeah, that's me.
Yeah, perfect.
Cool. Handsome. Look at you.
Jones. Dashing hair like a, what do you call it, a pomodoro or something? Oh, wait, that's a dog, isn't it?
Pomeranian.
A pomodoro.
A quaff.
A quaff.
I was listening. Pomodoro, that's
right. Zump. says, yeah, guys, this is interesting. Here, I'm going to shoot you guys this news article that just popped up on my feed.
Okay.
And he taps it in. And you guys' phone, bzz, 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 and it plays the following video.
Chaos, explosions, and automatic gunfire erupted today in a quiet suburb as a family found themselves caught in a massive running gun battle following a botched home invasion.
Knight Errant says the suspects arrived at the house in English Hill disguised as furniture delivery men and forced their way into the home.
KCPQ13's Diana Crawls explains what happened next.
This elf and this dwarf are standing on my porch on my security monitor, and I'm like, who are these clowns?
Nancy Henderson was home with her son and two daughters in their English Hill home when two armed intruders forced their way inside.
I kept telling them, I didn't order any furniture, I don't know who you are, and then this elf kicks the door in and hits me on the head with this huge gun.
Additional burglars, hidden in furniture boxes, attacked her two young daughters and her teenaged son.
A big scary orc jumped out of the box and pointed at me. I'm so scared. And he shouted at me with a gun.
The burglars spent several hours at the house, looking for drugs and new yen, but coming up empty.
I kept telling them, we don't have any drugs here. But they started prying up the floorboards. They were just convinced we had to have something.
That's when things got even crazier. A security patrol who just happened to be driving by spotted the illegally parked truck and came in to investigate. That's when the bullets started flying.
It was just rat-a-tat-tat-tat-tat-tat. It went on for about 5 minutes. Just non-stop shooting.
Henderson says the four burglars got back into their truck and drove away. Three security guards were killed in the exchange.
I'll never forget those faces. They're seared into my mind. And the bodies. Oh my God.
And she has this message for her attackers.
You came into our home. You attacked my children. And for what? For what? A handful of cred sticks?
Diana Crawls, KCPQ 13 News.
Knight Errant Security are hoping someone recognizes the faces in the video and turns them in. Anyone with information is encouraged to contact Knight Errant Security.
So, you guys all watch that, and then he closes it down.
So, what's the problem?
When I said none of the family was to be harmed, how did you interpret that?
Well, no one in the family is seriously injured.
Nothing permanent at all.
Did I say seriously injured?
Not specifically.
When I was a kid, I fell off a swing set and sprained my hand.
Mm-hmm.
It took a couple weeks to heal, but I wasn't harmed.
A lot of character actually built.
Yeah.
Right?
Listen, you contracted us to go in, get your delivery, and not to harm anyone. No one is harmed.
By the way, those are egregious lies on this. No one was hit over the head with a gun.
Look,
we didn't take any money from them.
No one
we
was
only
even
took
killed.
The package.
Okay, all right, I know. This is... They exaggerate things.
Mm-hmm.
It's
lot.
Fine.
Mm-hmm.
That kid with his messed up face, did that happen?
That's the one thing that did happen. But,
Did you
I think he's going to be better off.
I love his face.
You're a physical addict.
It's hard enough to knock him out. I'm pretty sure it left a bruise or a
Ketu
mark on him.
Famous for his giant knuckles.
Yeah.
All right. We all know that.
That was the only physical contact with anyone in the entire family.
And the orcs shooting at the kids?
Oh, those were just unconscious bolts. I don't even know what you're talking about.
What was he talking about? That was the kid saying that.
It was all gas. I used gas for everyone.
You gassed these people?
I have no idea what they're talking
it's
about. A weapon?
Safe.
I did not pull a weapon on anyone in that home.
Okay. All right. Jesus Christ.
Fox reports fake news.
Oh, God.
No, we can't do that.
Bye, guys. Bye, guys. It's been fun. Yeah, this is great.
We got warned by the powers that be.
No.
Okay.
He stopped.
Look.
I know.
This is fine.
Yeah.
My family or Trump support.
Listen, sometimes things go a little bit differently than your plans on a run like this.
For example, another shadow running team
showed up, what they call security guards, busted in on another mission, gunning for the same equipment.
But
they
were
not security guards.
You did reconnaissance though, right?
Yes, we did.
Mm-hmm.
And so you were aware of the team that was there?
We were aware that there was something else in the area and we were keeping an eye on it.
This is standard stuff that happens. There's going to be things that go wrong.
We handled it all nicely.
I don't think our Johnson is interested in this package.
That's fine. If you don't, if you want to call this deal off, I totally understand. Here. Yeah, get a drink on me, all right?
I don't think you want to do that.
Do what?
Call the deal off. Listen. I like you guys, okay?
I like you too.
I like you guys. You accomplished the mission. I'm not incredibly happy about how it was carried off. Everybody's still alive. So, news is out there. You should probably keep your heads down for a bit. They do have video footage of at least the dwarf. And I think it was you.
Tyler, in the video that he showed us, where is the
Did they show video clips? Did they show members of our team?
Yes, they
can
showed.
Can we see where it came from?
Yes, there was the video camera on the porch that was pointing when the dwarf and the elf walked up. And so you get a pretty good shot. You have a very nondescript face, but Gidget is
as I recall, she did go through a disguise so that she was not as noticeable.
That's true.
In terms of all that information.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she has a very distinctive style, but I mean that's one of her negative qualities.
And I was wearing a mustache. Yeah.
That's right. She didn't put makeup on. So we
did go through steps to make sure that the video wouldn't be anything that was caught on video wouldn't directly go, oh, that's the person.
Okay, yeah, that's fair.
And unless there were cameras on the inside, they didn't catch anybody else.
All the same, though, you probably want to lay low for a couple of
weeks. Of course.
So let's just say things happened and say that's that. So, you guys have the recipe on you.
We've got it nearby. Do you have the money on you?
Of course I do. What do you mean you have it nearby? Where is it?
We have it.
Well, get it!
Okay. Ooh.
Sorry,
A little spice. Are you all right?
Yeah. Okay. I thought you guys were bringing the recipe. I don't know. What is this? What game are we playing here?
I just wasn't sure if another Shadowrunning team was going to show up out of the blue or what was going to happen, you know?
You guys did your recon, right?
Yeah, we did.
Okay. Can you trust me? Can I trust you?
You can trust us.
Good. Let's cut through the bullshit. I'll take the recipe.
All right.
John, you stay here. I'll arrange it.
Right.
And I will get up from the table, and I'm going to come out of the bar, and where it's quieter, since I don't have to yell.
Okay.
And I'm going to give Ketu a clear signal.
Okay. So he pings you, Ketu.
Somersault him.
Hold on. All right. Oh, yeah.
Somersault him.
Bomb gives you a hand stamp when you leave, by the way.
Nice.
So.
That's good.
Yeah.
I'll have to pay him again.
Mm-hmm. Thanks, man.
You're gonna walk in?
I don't know if I should walk in with all that.
You're going to somersault in?
Do you want to come in?
Bomb catches your leg.
I guess let's do that.
All right.
Hey, bub.
Five new yen.
Got that right.
Shinka, 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 shinka.
Oh, my knives start falling out, too.
Oh, you're going to need to check those.
Will do.
All right.
There you go.
He sets you upright. Okay. You go over to the table.
Are you back at the table?
Well, I don't know which one of these figures is you.
I don't know which one is me either. Let's just take.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So as you come in, I will sort of come in behind you.
Perfect.
So in case anyone, I figure if it's in front, you'll be able to take care of anything, but I'll be able to guard your back.
Right by the stage.
She's table. My cherry pie. It's on a repeat. This is the next answer. She had already arranged it with a DJ that's the song she would dance to. She was just a little pissed off.
She was really upset
at the first girl.
Cindy, you stole my music!
That little bitch!
Well, somebody has to change.
So,
oh my God.
Not gonna be me.
Cycling through again.
And then I didn't want my back to the door, so I'm gonna go here.
Okay. So he's like.
And I will
can't blame us for taking precautions.
I'm just gonna come here and lean up against the bar.
Yep. All right. Keanu's there, by the way. So, or no, sorry, Bill S. Preston, Esquire.
Right.
That's what
Whoa, hey, it's you, Orc Guy. Can I get you a drink?
Yeah.
Awesome. All right.
Whiskey sour, and I'll just drop some creds on the table for you.
Yeah, let me go look that up real quick.
Look it up.
And a whiskey sour.
Yes.
Sorry, Ted Theodore. Sorry, you're right. Ted Theodore Logan.
Oh, right.
Oh, yeah. God.
So it's excellent.
That's terrible. Yeah. Yeah. Excellent.
Did you hear the good news, though?
Yeah, I know. It is good news. It's the best news. All right, so he goes and gets you a drink. You sit down, and Mr. Johnson looks at you. He's like, so you have the recipe?
I do, but you seem a bit nervous. No.
No.
bit of sweat on your underbrow there.
Just want this deal to be completed, you know?
Mm-hmm. I want to, while they're doing that, I'm going to cast Clairvoyance.
Okay.
And I'm going to use it to check out the entire interior of the location.
Okay. Yeah, so this is the one where your little eyeball kind of goes...
It's where my vision is replaced by wherever I want within the range of the spell to be my vision. So I can walk it around anywhere I want within the range of the spell.
Okay. The dressing room is warded.
That makes sense.
You freaking weirdo.
That makes a lot of sense.
As are the back rooms, the bathroom and the champagne rooms. Okay. Those are magically warded as well.
Which seems reasonable, but I'm going to keep special attention on those areas.
Okay. Can I do a quick just judge intentions real fast?
Sure. Yeah.
I think this is 13, right? For I'll check
it. This is one. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Cool.
Judge intentions. That's what.
Do you want my dice and everything?
Oh, you're gonna assist?
No, no, no. I mean for my spell.
Oh yeah, please.
What attribute is
Christmas plus intuition?
Intuition.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. That's cool. Assist.
Willpower versus charisma.
You okay, Chris.
Huh?
Doing okay?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. Yeah, thanks, Chris. Okay.
No sweat.
How many hits
you guys gotta get paid. Four. I mean, this is pretty important.
Yeah. Four? Okay. Against two.
Yeah.
He is nervous because he is excited. Okay. And he is scared that he's going to...
Dude's addicted to Coca-Cola.
He's scared that you guys are going to run off with the recipe.
Okay. I got five successes, which is my... my perception tests have a limit of five
okay.
for anything that I see.
Cool.
During this time period.
Okay.
This is a force five spell, so I don't recall exactly, but I'm pretty sure it's like yards times force, like 5 yards per force time. So I should be able to get the whole building, be able to see anywhere I want in the building.
Okay.
Just move it around. Yep. And let me give you my drain test. which is three and then minus two. Quick question. With it's a hit, do I have to use those ahead of time or can I
apply
them retroactively?
Yeah, you can add it retroactively.
That's enough to resist the two drain.
Okay.
So fine.
Cool. All right, yeah. So you're able to look around. What are you looking for specifically?
He just seems nervous, and I don't know, you know, the sense motives or anything. Right. So I'm looking for the ambush.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm paying a special attention to the warded areas.
Okay.
I'm not trying to defeat the ward. I just want to know if anyone comes out of there who is armed or trouble, that I'm going to alert my team and immediately go to the defensive.
Got it.
But beyond that, I'm just sort of like, I'm just moving my sight all the way around to kind of get a 360 vision while it looks like I'm just leaning on the bar staring at the at the stage.
You got it.
All right, so is this a direct deposit or cash?
No, certified cred sticks.
Ah, excellent. Oh, that's right.
You knew that though, right?
Yeah, I would have known that yesterday.
Yeah.
He was testing it.
Good, good. All right, glad we're on the same page here. So, first of all, Nick, you do not see any ambush.
Okay.
Nothing out of the ordinary.
I'm ready to just get this done.
Okay, all right, cool. So he reaches into his little briefcase, pulls out, counts it, puts out four piles of cred sticks.
Is there any way to verify them?
Five piles of cred
sticks. Oh, is it five? That's right, Grabsy. Oh, yeah, shit, I forgot about Grabsy. Okay.
And Papa Chops.
I think that was legitimate.
Actually, no, you did negotiate six.
I negotiated six stacks.
Okay. but that was when he wasn't there, so you'll have to pay Papa Chocks out of your...
Oh, that's true.
So.
That's true.
Well,
he won't collect. He won't collect. He's a sweetheart.
He's a darling.
He's a, yeah.
Okay,
I'll just say, remember this when I come around for the orphans.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Yeah.
Okay, cool. So yeah, you can slot it into your comlink.
Yeah, just give it a quick
and, yeah, just pulling out. Okay. Man, he's a man of his word.
All right. Yeah.
Okay, so, the...
Oh, yeah, sure.
Be careful with that.
All right.
Took some doing.
He gets it.
Yeah, just like I imagine that, like, landed in a puddle of, like, goo on the table, goo. And it's like, he lifts it back up, and...
It just smells like beer and sadness now.
All right, he scans it over.
Okay. Did any of you guys take a photo of it, just out of curiosity?
No.
Actually, no. I think Gidget did take a photo.
I took a brain photo too.
Yeah, yeah.
Cool. And she and he slots it in the briefcase.
Everything look good?
We're good.
A lot of sugar.
Yeah.
Feel free to stay and enjoy the show.
We'll probably head out, but I know things were a little shaky for this mission. But don't hesitate to call on us again if you need anything. All right?
You guys are good. Okay, we're good. You guys did a good job. Everything's good. You good? You're good.
I'm a. He would. He'd be good? Shouting.
You're good? Hey! Are you good?
I'll nod.
That's good.
Are you good? I can't hear you!
Moonbiter nods.
He's nodding. He's good.
Okay! Right. He's good.
Yeah.
He's good. He's good. Cool! Alright, well, I gotta go drop this off then.
Get it, man. Conquer the world.
Yeah. Good luck. I don't shake hands, but...
That's fine.
Yeah. And so he walks awkwardly out of the gooey duck.
I say we get out of here as soon as possible because I don't trust that guy. And yeah, let's go have a beer somewhere.
Okay, cool. So
I'll snap vision back, and we'll head out.
Very good. You guys did it.
Woo!
Paid up.
Only an hour and a half to collect your goddamn money.
No.
That was amazing.
Hey, can you blame us for being a little paranoid?
That's right. That's right.
Better. It took three. Meetings to get the fucking
recipe. Yeah, line it up in the first place.
Yep. Yeah. All right.
Forgot about
that. Cool. So, game time passes, and it's going to be 2 weeks worth of stuff.
Okay.
All right? We don't have to do this tonight. We can figure it out over Slack over the week. Gidget is here. I'm going to put Gidget back in her little home, because Gidget goes and does what Gidget does. You guys have 9,000 new yen is, I think, what the final negotiated price. I'm looking at you because you negotiated it, and I didn't write it down.
Oh, in that case, it was 15,000.
All right,
We got three up front, and then we had a payout of 10.
Yes, it was a 10.
He talked him up to 13.
That's right, it was
13. He wanted to pay us 9 each, yeah. And you were like, hey, this is a rush job, and... You know, you don't give us any information to go on, blah, blah, blah. Yeah.
Thanks, man.
You did a good job.
Nice face work.
Thank you.
Cool. So, yeah.
I don't remember it going that well, but hey, it's whatever.
A total
cool.
of 13K.
Yeah.
But we got three of it earlier.
Yes. Yeah, I think that sounds right. I thought it was 10, but either way, yeah.
So how are we splitting that bad boy? Ooh.
Oh, it's each.
No, each.
Oh, each?
Yeah, yeah. Per person.
Hey!
Hey! Oh!
Holla!
Hip hop crew.
So I have a rules question if we're going sort of into that real quick.
Go ahead.
This downtime.
Go ahead.
So I was reading in the Shadowrun Core rules book
that
when you're trying to improve skills... for those of you following at home, I'm looking at pages 105 and 106 in the core rulebook. But it says that you can go ahead and improve two different skills, one physical and one mental,
sure.
During the same time period.
Okay.
But not two physical or two mental, one of each.
Okay.
On there. How does that apply to things that are skill groups? Do they fall into just one of those categories and you can raise the group plus another additional skill or attribute, or is it just
so the
or
skill
does that count as everything?
The skill groups have both physical and mental.
Well, what the specifics are, I want to increase one of my spellcasting skill groups.
Okay.
So I figure that would pretty much all be mental.
Yes.
On there.
Yes.
Could I still also increase a physical type skill if I wanted to?
Yes.
Great.
Yep.
Okay.
Good looking out.
Yeah.
All right.
Cool. Quick question too.
Yeah.
So, does the 3,000 I started with, is that just what I started with as my character, or was that the 3,000 that we got?
That was the 3,000 you got up front.
Cool. Right on.
Okay. Cool. So 2 weeks pass. We can discuss this offline, so as not to have a book learning session, and in order to
I brought books.
in order to facilitate the appearance of Mr. Trollperson. Everybody gets a buzzer on their little comlink. Their little comlink lights up with a little red flashing lights. It is a message from Grabsy. And
my comlink rings off. Or
Are you ready?
When you...
you gotta stop doing that. That's super annoying.
When you open the message, it is a voice message from Grabzy. It is a group voice message. And in it, Grabzy says, Hey guys, it's your old pal Grabzy. Listen, I think I might have got a lead on a job that you guys might want to be interested in. It's a big, it's a fancy Mr. Johnson, who I've known for a while. Anyway, I got a meet set up at noon this Saturday. If you guys want to come, it's at the Bothell Landing Park up in Bothell. He wants to meet us at the picnic table in the park on the far right, and just meet us there, and then he'll be there. Anyway, this is Grabzy. See you then. Bye.
He didn't say what time, did he?
12 p.m.
Oh, I did.
Noon. Okay.
Noon. So we're all like our own separate places.
Yeah, you're now. All scattered to the winds.
And runners assemble. No.
Hard.
Yeah. Did you just Care Bear stare it?
Yeah.
It's a ring, bud. It's all right. That's all right. You just gotta mix them.
Mixing his fandoms.
All right.
All four in the heart.
Yeah.
It is Valentine's.
You might say I'm crossing the streams.
I would never say.
Oh my God, you nerd.
You're too wise for that.
Will do himself in our chaos. Will
oh, no.
do.
Don't like
okay,
that.
So do you guys all make it to the park?
I'm down.
Okay, that done.
Done.
Gidget is unavailable, unfortunately. Mm. Yes.
Oh yeah, that's right. It's robot fight championships that weekend.
Yeah. That's too bad. Exactly. She loves her robot fights.
Hosted by Allison Hayslip.
Yep.
That's a weird reference.
Allison Hayslip.
Wasn't she the BattleBots girl?
It's the fourth reincarnation of BattleBots.
Never mind. Move on.
That was an amazing pull, though. Solid. The granddaughter of Allison Hayslip, I guess.
Didn't Chobot go on that for a bit?
Oh, no, it's Allison Hayslip's head in a jar. Attached to a bot.
Best part of her.
I miss when it was Lister. You guys remember when it was Lister from Red Dwarf? He was doing the BattleBot stuff?
I don't.
It wasn't BattleBots, it was the other, it was like
Robot Wars.
Robot Wars, yeah.
You don't see me yet, by the way. I'm like hanging out in a tree, watching.
Okay.
So, yeah, when you arrive, this is the scene that you see. The park at Bothell Landing has managed to keep its turn-of-the-century quaintness intact, with a small slum of Bothell crumbles around it. The graffiti is not as obscene as what you'd see in most parks, and there are actually a few honest-to-God children playing on the faded plastic playground area. The heavily polluted Sammamish River burbles beneath a centuries-old wooden footbridge leading to the notoriously dangerous Sammamish River Trail. There's a picnic table festooned with streamers near the middle of the park, with a large banner that reads, "Happy Birthday, Jason!" in large, colorful colors. An enormous troll is hefting a large hot plate of eggs across the lawn toward the table. His truck, tastily labeled Deus Ex Machina, idles quietly in the parking lot.
That's really good.
An attractive middle-aged woman is inflating balloons at one end of the table, while Grabzy sits on the bench, tapping listlessly on his comlink.
So he's at the birthday party.
I like that you said, like, honest to goodness kids and not like soy kids. like vat grown, high GMO kids.
Yeah, exactly. Nothing is real.
I will walk over and sit on the, like, the far end of the bench that Grabzy's at.
Uh huh.
But is he turned towards the table?
He is just kind of on his comlink.
Right, but is he sitting like the way you'd normally sit at a park bench, or is he sitting?
He is facing in this direction. Wait, where's Grabzy? Where are you, Grabzy? There you are. Okay. He's sitting here, facing toward the parking lot, checking up every once in a while. I'm going back to his comlink.
We got saffron fried eggs.
So yeah. So you are over here. And then everybody except for him.
Probably not
our Mr. Johnson. He was invited, but he declined.
Who am I kicking it with?
That's Grabzy.
Hell yeah, Grabzy.
That's Grabzy.
Oh yeah, he's got the deck. That makes sense.
So.
Well, I'm just going to Well, I guess we meet in the parking lot or something. Huh? So. How you guys been? Spending that money wisely?
Good. Just taking a little time off, let the heat die down.
Eggs.
Yeah, you guys smell that?
I'll pop in there.
Is that saffron?
Wait, should I roll to see if it actually smells good? Smells like shit.
I love that you're hawking eggs.
Eggs.
You know, we're gonna eat the eggs. So I mean, you don't have to keep telling. You know, I'm not gonna tell you how to do your job. Just
did we get this like yesterday or earlier?
You got it. You got it 2 days ago.
Okay. Do you guys have any idea what Grabs' job is?
No, no idea at all.
No, I just got a message. Was meet here.
All right, this time. Well, let's go find out.
So the troll hawking the eggs is, like trolls tend to be, like 8.5 feet tall. He's a ginger.
Thanks.
Like very beautiful red hair.
Braided.
You know, like. Yeah, sure. No, yeah, it's good. You know, long horns, like Ludo from Labyrinth. Big apron, and it's a greasy spoon apron, but it's like tent sized. No super obvious cyber, I think. I'm gonna double check that. Pretty sure he's no super obvious cyber, but like big and not particularly charismatic, but like smiling kind of. Unintelligently, the way unintelligent people smile. You know what I mean. You know what I mean.
You guys know what we're talking about, yeah. Right?
Yeah.
Just if we had Sean. I had a moment, I was channeling Sean for a moment.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, that's, oh, yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What?
Mm-hmm. We would say something viciously mean about the chat.
About the chat.
Where Sean
Oh, here. Got it,
yeah.
Got it.
Yeah.
He might have said something like, you know, like you see in the mirror every day. I would never say that. That's something that Sean might have said.
I don't know.
I missed you.
Okay, Grabsy looks up and he goes, oh my god, you guys made it! Oh, hey, yeah, cool. Hey, how's it going?
Good, Grabsy, how are you?
Good, John.
How you been?
Moonbiter, Ketu, pretty good, pretty good. You know, guys, welcome to...
You got a birthday party going on here?
I'm sorry, it was, I apologize. I may have brought you here under some false pretext, but it is my 17th birthday today. And so I thought you guys might just enjoy a little bit of, we have some eggs and...
Eggs!
Yes,
right.
And I mean, is there gonna be bread or is it all just?
I conspicuously look up at the sad sign that says "Happy Jason. Birthday, Jason."
Yeah,
I don't say anything. I don't say anything. I just look at it and then back and grab it.
Why does that say Jason?
Huh? Oh, some people call me Jason. I mean,
is that what your mother calls you?
Some people call him the Jace Cowboy.
When I've been bad.
Oh. Well, dang! I didn't know it was your birthday. I would have brought something.
Oh no, it's fine. You guys don't need to go to any trouble. Your presence is enough for me. So help yourself. We have eggs and
eggs.
And some different varieties of eggs.
That's
Grabsy. I keep telling you, you're part of the team. It's okay to just
that's the saffron.
Say you want to hang out or see something.
I mean, you know, there's going to be like a ton of people showing up, and so I, you know,
they're lizard eggs.
So
yeah,
it should be here any minute. But you know, I thought it would be kind of a fun little prank to pull on you guys, so you know, but I just thanks for showing up. This really means a lot to me.
Hey,
so
means a lot to us that you'd invite us.
Happy birthday.
Thanks. So yeah, grab some
eggs are good.
Some of the food here that we got.
Is it good?
Let's see. Okay, hang on.
So I'm feeling there's like an eggs Benedict.
There is. And it's
eggs to order.
Yeah, I mean, why not? Like,
it's a lizard egg Benedict with instead of like Canadian bacon because that's like super expensive. It's
right. Soy bacon. UCAS bacon.
Right.
That's right. It's our bacon. It's
exactly.
Bacon.
Exactly. Yeah.
It's just bacon.
I got one success on my seasonings check.
Nice. Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, you know, I should have come with like a full pun menu. And I'm so sorry.
We've
that
got
I,
2 weeks.
I, yeah, yeah. Okay. Yeah.
For next time.
Bob
yeah.
Burgers.
Yeah.
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 So yeah, help yourself. Grab an Aztec cola, get some soy chips, and you know, make yourself at home. We have some. Have some festivities planned very soon. So yeah. And Grabsy's mom is kind of sitting apart. She's just, you know, doting on her boy. She's just happy to be here. Mm. I gotta make some phone calls. I'm expecting probably about a dozen more people. So
Yeah. All right.
Great. Sounds good.
I'm gonna sidle on over and talk to his mom.
Sausage platter. I got the sausage platter.
She's a she is a human, oddly enough, and very, very nice looking. Very kind of distant, you know, but friendly enough. She seems friendly. And she's like, "Oh, you must be John."
I am John. How did you know?
Oh, Grabsy's talked so much about you.
Oh, really?
Yes. Uh-huh. She says you're quite a little charmer.
His mother calls him Grabsy?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, great. Oh, yeah. Cool.
I only call him Jason when he's misbehaving. His real name is Jason. I know how you Shadowrunners like your little secret names. So
oh, it's so
I
you...
will never tell.
Okay. I didn't know that you knew about that either.
Oh, you guys. He tells me everything. You guys are great. You must be Ketu.
Oh, how did you know?
We talk. He has such fun with you guys. You guys, it's been great getting him out of the house. I
flashbacks
tell you.
Of all the murder. Yeah.
Oh my God, I'm dying! What's happening? There's so much blood.
I feel like she reads his Twitter feed, but she thinks he's like LARPing or something.
Yes. Right.
Oh, you Shadowrunners.
Right.
No, this is you and your Shadowrun.
I looked it up. Games. It's an RPG for the 21st century. Exactly. You guys are keeping the dream alive. I get it.
You have your little handles, and each one of you likes to go by your handles. So, yes.
Well, this is a delightful party put
no,
together.
Unfortunately, no.
Okay.
Well, you know, we like to throw him something nice. It was his sweet 16 last year, so nothing can compare to that.
It's a pretty big one.
Oh yeah, we went to the SimSense arcade, and he just had a blast.
Oh, that's good. I know how he loves arcades.
He does. He's a great kid. He's a great kid.
Oh
so
yeah.
Thank you guys for taking care of him and taking him on your little adventures.
It is our genuine pleasure.
Oh. Stop.
No.
That's
I'm
good
gonna grab a, we, I do have some adult beverages if you are all interested.
Not
so
on
feel free
that.
To help yourself.
Right
you
away.
Just hear the a patter like like platter like clang. Sorry, what?
Oh yes. I suppose you can go ahead and help yourself too. We have some synth beer and. I have a little bit of synth gin, but that's, you know, I keep that in a little glass because...
Sneaky peek.
Yeah, right? So yeah, help yourself.
I don't consume alcohol, but I will have a juice if you don't mind.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, just a juice in the cooler.
I'm going to cock block it.
Grabs is getting a little worried because he was... You know, there's supposed to be some more people here.
Oh, no.
And he's getting a little
so
like.
Yeah, you guys ordered catering for 50?
Yeah, well, you know, it's still early. You know, people are, they feel kind of late. And so,
sure, of course.
Right around 12:30, car pulls up. And a guy and a woman walk out. Sort of it's a Ford America car, which is sort of your kind of run-of-the-mill.
Just like mine.
Average family car.
I have a Ford America car.
They get
it's
out.
A good car. Very reliable.
Guy has got a little duffel bag. Girl looks like, if there was a trid that was called the Shadowrunner Girl, that's what she's dressed like. She's got like spiked, you know, pink spiked mohawk hair and like a spiked collar and like heavy makeup. And she just looks like she dropped out of like a.
You mean like this one right here?
Pretty close. Yeah.
Like with
and
hair.
The goggles. With with her hair and the goggles and she's definitely got a katana on.
You
back.
Know the Shadowrun girl found on page zero.
For those of you who are following along at home.
So it is just the cliched Shadowrun girl. Little midriff showing, because of course. The guy is dressed like, again, the cliche Mr. Johnson. He's got the fedora, and it's like...
The trench coat.
Trench coat, and it's popped
at
up.
Noon.
At noon. He is sweating, but you know what? We got to do this. And he's got the little
over
bag.
Concealment over comfort, right?
And what's that?
Concealment over comfort.
Every time. Because you never know. Mm-hmm. And so
they
cross the lawn, and the Mr. Johnson takes the duffel off.
I walk up to them with a platter of
biscuits. Straight up.
It's the biscuits platter.
Oh my god, you actually have biscuits.
Biscuits.
It's not all eggs.
No, it's full brunch.
Oh my
full brunch.
Yeah. All right.
Biscuits.
The Johnson's like, I don't have time for biscuits. Maybe later. All right. Which one of you is Grabsy? I'm Grabsy. Like, all right. You got my comlink message? Yeah. Yeah, I sure did. I sure did. All right. Are you an experienced runner? Yeah, I'm a very experienced runner. Okay.
Who's is this his mom?
Yes.
Okay, so that's his mom. I'm gonna kind of drop back over here while they're talking.
Where's my truck? Where's my
Your truck is over here. So you've been kind of walking stuff back and forth.
I'm walking this way then.
He's like, okay, great. How many experienced Shadowrunners do I have here? I'm looking for only the best of the best.
I'm sorry, I just have to jump. I have to jump out of here for just a moment. Is this the Shadowrunner version of, like, Megan and Jordan?
He looks suspiciously like Megan and Jordan.
Okay, all right.
If you could describe, you know, kind of a taller, skinny
guy. I just want to make sure I'm picking up what you're putting down, that's all.
Yeah, yeah, and then the other one kind of, you know, has sort of a Jennifer Love Hewitt thing-ish. Going on, so like, yeah, you could say, right. You know, the famous Jordan Caves and Megan Kellerman from the 21st century, early 21st century.
Yes. Oh, wow. Yeah.
They went on to do amazing things.
Yes.
So, yeah. It looks very similar to them.
All right.
Which one of you, how many experienced Shadowrunners we got here?
I'm going to check in with Grabsy and see what he's, like, if he's, like, cute.
I'm experienced Shadowrunner.
Look at the mom.
Oh no, I'm fine.
It's never too late to start Shadowrunning.
You. He said to keep an eye on you. He did.
I'll look at John, sigh a little bit to myself, and go here.
Ha! All right, here. Check these on. Go ahead and chuck these over your head.
What is it?
Put these things. It's a pair of AR goggles. You just put them on. Put them over your eyes.
It's just a paper bag. Here, put it on.
Just go ahead and start looking at
yourself. It's a burlap sack.
Here, just hold your hands out like this, real quick.
Does he give it both of us?
Yeah, give it a little pop. How about you, little man? Are you an experienced Shadowrunner?
Give me those.
Yeah, it's for granted.
All right. Cool. Hey, big dude. You look like you're a pretty capable man.
Biscuits?
No way, man. I ate before I got here. What do you say? All right.
I'm just a chef, but I'm curious.
Cool.
All right.
Everything's in 3D.
Yes. You find yourself.
I don't know if I can do that.
Minor Vogues.
Like, you put it on, and it's just like these are basically just AR or VR goggles.
She told us to bring goggles.
So it's augmented reality. So you still see the world around you. Like it's not like VR goggles where you're just completely blanked out. You see it, and then just stuff kind of just pops up, and the girl is sort of, you know, typing stuff into a little console, it loads up the first location, and it is a bar.
The gun racks from The Matrix? Cool.
No kung fu.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. It was perfect.
That's exactly
yeah, it was very evocative, yeah.
When you said gun rack, I immediately thought of Wayne's World for some reason, sorry.
Exactly, let alone many guns that would necessitate a gun rack. I've never seen that movie in my life. Go ahead.
Yeah.
I've never seen that movie 15 times every day.
Sense intention.
So you are all sort of standing around. He hasn't changed your persona at all, except you all, it's kind of like a Snapchat filter. So you're kind of like, you know, you've got like a sweet mohawk and like, you know, ear piercings and, you know, you look...
So I look normal.
Yeah, so you look normal. Not a whole lot has been done. There's like, they sort of put a filter over all you guys so that you like a little, you know, there's a lot more leather and fucking spikes and shit like that. And so,
like I said, like I'm basically unchanged.
Yes,
then.
Yes.
Moonbiter looks exactly the same.
The computer went over to you and was like, maybe a face tattoo?
Yeah.
Or, I don't know. Yeah.
Am I still wearing an apron in my avatar?
No, it's a big leather duster. No.
Oh, yeah. Okay, cool.
So, it's
impractical for making biscuits, but yeah.
You can still see the apron underneath, so it's just like apron duster.
Yeah, cool. Yeah.
Like, this is really not practical anymore.
It's covered in flour.
So, it's late. Your comlink buzzes to life with a private message, audio and visual, video. A Native American dwarf grins from the feed. He wears denim from head to toe with the sleeves cut off his jacket. Across one bicep is a nanotat proclaiming, I heart mayhem. Hello, friends. I'm Reno Pryant, and I've got an opportunity for you. Simple job, milk run, really. Shouldn't be too difficult for runners of your caliber. I need to know within the hour if you're interested. I've tagged my number to the end of this feed. If you're in, I'll give you the meeting specs when you call back.
Oh, we're in.
I mean,
Grabsy. You're calling the shots on this one.
Yeah.
Are we in? Nice.
So I'm gonna.
That's a good call.
I'm gonna play the face. I have several credits banked already with these guys. So I am going to select the.
Are your toes thoroughly stepped on?
It'll be fun to play brute.
I'm going to select the face. It's one of the premium shadow running positions. So I'm going to select the face, and you know, feel free to pick whatever.
See what options we have. We have like physical adept, magical adept, like ninja person, Decker.
Yeah, well, that's a premium one. The ones you get to choose from are samurai, street samurai, mage, shaman, and rigger. Those are the four base classes.
Shaman for sure.
I see how this is going. All right.
Or you can spend some money to get one of the improved classes, which is, you know, physical adept, mystic adept. There's a couple of different
Shaman
options.
Shaman sounds great to me. That sounds perfect.
Do you feel that?
How much is the mysticism is the physical adept?
Huh?
How much is physical adept?
That's an extra 10 million.
All right.
Let the circle of toe stepping continue.
All right. Good choice. We got ourselves a physical adept here, guys. Watch out. Magic Punch is going to be flying. What about you, little dude?
The bartender's here?
That's a pretty good... I'd say that was a pretty good Jordan impression, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It was spot on.
Impeccable.
Yeah.
Yeah. How about you, little man? What's it going to be?
It's for Grabsy.
Sorry, Mara. You end up being him. So, he's so, me.
You should probably be the Decker.
I'm the face. Oh, I'm the face.
Yeah, a rigger, Decker or Rigger. Yeah.
Decker. That's right. Yeah, Decker is a base class too. Right.
You just play the samurai. You just play yourself.
Yeah. I know I forget one.
Physical adept. Oh, and you're physical adept? Okay. So. Okay, and then
yeah,
what
so
we're just, all sorts of magic punches flying around.
We're just all, I think we're just swapping ones.
I can't wait to see what you bring to the table, my man.
And Ludo, super not being in on the joke at all, is just like, street samurai. Look at me.
All right, man. All right.
So I have a question.
I think you can take some punches.
So as we make these selections, I assume that our AR persona morphs a little more into that that thing.
Yep.
So Grabsy is looking at like the peak charismatic version of Grabsy.
Yes, as much as you can polish
like
a turd.
All tribaled out.
Yeah.
Over your suit, you're all tribaled out.
I mean, what were the premium ones? Were there any ridiculous things like chef?
No, it was the physical adepts. Actually, I think Rigor is probably going to be a premium one, just because of
the number, the processing power on
the number of pages. Oh, that's yes, right. Exactly. Yeah, okay. And then there's Mystic Adept, and then there's just one where you can kind of customize it.
Oh, you know what? Grabsy is just a client of mine at this point. His mom is. Mm. I owe him no loyalty. I'll take Decker.
Okay. All right. Hey, man.
Oh, wait. Did you take Decker? I'll take Face.
No, I didn't get to pick.
No, Grabsy
took Face.
Exactly.
two faces, huh? You know, that's...
Well, you just made it look so fun.
You know, yeah. No, it's... we're going to totally make this work. God, I cannot... I dropped everything over here.
I'm going to take off my tie, actually, and I'm going to put it over Grabsy.
Oh, wow. You tied that really well.
Yeah.
All right. Cool.
I mean, so long as we're in the virtual, I might as well pretend I have charisma.
Aww.
So I think Moonbiter, like, there's an overlay of like the black jumpsuit thing, like Ketu normally wears, but it keeps clipping with the giant duster and the spikes and stuff that he's wearing through it. So it's like the whenever I move, there's like the and then it's like processes to remove that from the from the AR.
You look like smoke is starting to come out of
the simulator physics.
Yeah,
he's just like.
You can see like an apron peeking out of my like popped black silk collar that's been it's unbuttoned to reveal like a troll chest hair, but there's an apron clearly tucked underneath it.
Like just perfect. Robes, just straight up robes, and like a big old hood over the front.
He is in seventh heaven right now. He's like,
I have a fedora hanging off a single horn. Just floating in air right there.
Classy.
Yeah. Yeah. You're the only person that's ever accused Ludo of being classy.
Hey, Dom.
Yeah.
Do we have any coffee?
Coffee?
Yeah.
Oh, no, we're losing Makayla.
Sorry.
We have soda pop.
Yeah, we have soda
pop. Is it Coca-Cola? We now know what's in it.
There's a monster in here.
Yeah.
No.
Oh, God.
Sounds delightful.
I've never had an energy drink before.
Oh, no.
We better do it on camera.
Right?
Huh?
$15 donation.
You're sitting next to her.
What time do you have to get up tomorrow?
I don't want my heart to explode.
It only explodes a little.
Straight from the cake.
Oh, just shotgun it?
Could we get? Oh, I guess it would take a while.
This has got pepper. That's pepper's fine. Got a little bit of caffeine.
They don't have a Keurig here?
No, Dr. Pepper?
Yes, Coca-Cola does too, but pepper probably has no one.
Oh, like with the little the flavor pack thingies? Yeah, we have one of those at work. My work. Okay. So cool. All right. And so what class did you choose then, Ketu?
I'm gonna do the Mystic Adept.
Oh, you're gonna pay for the bonus Mystic Adept?
Mm-hmm.
All right, yeah. Cool. So you guys are all locked in. Your hands start to glow with magic energy, and your eyes sort of fizzle. And there's just you have sort of a you're wearing robes now.
Wait, what is that? You're at one with the mystical force. Oh no!
So Grabsy the face. Yeah. He's like, well,
face.
The face has to call the.
A face has to call.
I mean, if you want to call the guy.
No, I don't want to.
No, I'll call him back.
No, go ahead.
Okay. All right.
Just choose your articles correctly.
As this gets started.
Okay.
And I see this going down. I'm gonna walk over to the chef.
More eggs.
No. But.
Is your food not?
No. Everything is great.
Oh, okay.
But if you could do me a favor.
Yeah.
This is really important to Grabsy.
Yeah.
And I was just wondering. Yes, to Jason.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. This is really important to Grabsy is the handle he goes by in these games. And it really, kicks off. I was just wondering if I could talk to you as, Orc to Troll here about maybe choosing something else. Because it's kind of special for him. I was just wondering if maybe you could choose a different class.
Okay.
Thanks. I appreciate it. Yeah.
You do this out of earshot of Grabsy?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I could. Yeah. Yeah. All sorry. Right. I should have thought of that. It's clearly his birthday.
Grabsy's on the phone with the Mr. Johnson. So,
My avatar comes back and, I just got a big cyber deck across my back and, like, just wires coming out of my head.
Perfect.
I switched. So you're the face now.
He's, okay. Oh, cool. Well, I got us the job.
Oh.
So.
Good work.
Okay, great. Grabs you out. Great.
God, he hung up on me.
He said, fantastic. Meet me at my place in 1 hour. So we got an hour to get to his place.
Well, we had best get going.
I look over Ketu and just go. Just grunt.
Yeah, guys, let's go.
All right. So the world kind of vanishes around you. While the woman is just kind of sitting there loading up the next thing. Everybody give me a perception check.
Is there like a menu for us to do something in our quote unquote 1 hour downtime? Like a little microtransaction?
Yes,
like
yes.
If you want to, you know, do you want to power up a gun or something like that?
Exactly, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Perception check, you said? Hmm. Okay, I grabbed the right number of dice.
Wait. I sense something.
Do you?
Yeah, you definitely do.
Okay, so give me who got what? How many
three. Did you get?
Two. Three.
One.
Okay. So anybody with three successes.
It's a delightful song.
Yeah.
Where'd you get that?
It's a classic. You notice something a little out of the ordinary. Right over here.
Ghost?
You see a guy dressed like an Old West gunslinger and a nun. with kind of crazy face tattoos. And they're like a little, all their clothing is a little bit distressed. And
I don't see this yet.
So this is anybody who's got a three through your AR goggles, you kind of see this, and they're like looking at you.
We're being watched.
Look at each other, and you start walking off.
Did they look VR? Like, do they look similar to, or is it hard to tell?
What's that?
Do they look VR, or, like, overtly, or is it hard to tell?
Anybody who made their perception rolls, do you have any gang, gang-related skills? Gang knowledge?
I feel like I do. Hold on.
If only I'd rolled more successes.
Right? What would it be under? It'd be
it's a
gang knowledge?
Knowledge skill?
Yeah, it's a knowledge skill.
Usually it's a knowledge skill. Yeah.
No, so, I have Shadow of Fashion, psychology, sprawl, business. Sprawl life.
Fashion.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, if you say we're being watched, do you tell them?
Well, wait a minute. Could he maybe use fashion if they are a gang that is associated with a particular style of dress?
Sure. Well, I'll take that.
All right. Good looking.
Well, I can be convinced of that.
Well done.
Okay. Doo-doo.
That's the right place, right time karma boost, I think.
Ha! One.
They are dressed strange.
Pretty weird.
Feels like they're dressed up in costumes of some kind.
Okay.
I think I don't see any of this because I'm so not used to the whole AR experience
right.
for the most
That's
part
good.
That it's kind of disorienting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. they're odd. Looks like, I mean, they look like a street gang, but they're like dressed up in a costume, which is very strange.
Mm. Yay!
All right, guys.
Wow, they spared no expense on this AR experience.
So, are you guys ready to? Are you ready to tackle this next mission?
Oh, just one second. I pull off the goggle and I address his mother.
Uh-huh.
Can I do this without getting a bad review on?
You're fine.
Okay, it's for your boy.
We're taking care of, you're fine, you're taken care of. Don't have fun, okay? Have fun. Hopefully his friends will be showing up soon.
Great.
So,
help yourself to the
It's delicious. It's delicious, by the way.
Okay.
So thank you.
Yeah, no, my pleasure.
All right. So, to...
Future Yelp. I just don't want to get eviscerated on Future Yelp.
Walk out to the street. They hop on a Dodge Scoot.
Good Doppler effect.
Thank you. The Doppler effect. Thank you.
I'm sure that won't come back to bite us in the rear.
All right.
It should be fine.
And...
Hashtag worst Shadowrun team ever.
You find yourself in a bar, in Reno Piet's bar. Reno's is clean, given that it's a low-end bar and grill. The floors are freshly swept, the few empty tables wiped down, the smell of beer, smoke, and charred meat fills the air. The waitstaff bustles back and forth, serving members of all races with equal attention. The bouncer stops you as you enter, examining you with a careful eye. He says, "You're new here, so I'll let you know up front. Vendettas are checked at the door. No fighting or you get barred. Understand?"
We didn't dream of it.
How about you? Little crazy glowing girl.
I'm so tired.
I'm sorry. You good? Thumbs up? Give me a nod? All right. How about you? Big stuff.
Yeah.
Big man.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wire man.
Yeah. What?
Right.
Oh, that's right. Because the yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, let's.
All right. Party's in the back. Last table on the left, near the bar.
How excited is Krabsy at this?
Krabsy is overjoyed. He's having a blast. He is facing around, looking at himself in the mirror. It's just wonderful.
All right.
Okay. All right, Reno, you guys go to the back of the bar, and you see Reno Piet sitting there. He's a dwarf, sort of a fat dwarf wearing a nice suit with a vest, he eyes you coolly, and he says, "I have a package that's supposed to be delivered tonight. Fortunately, the smuggler in question, Thelbin Wrongway, has angered a street gang called the Kickers. Right now, he's holed up with my package in an abandoned hardware store near the Everett Ferry Terminal." He sips again at the drink before continuing. "What I need from you is a distraction so the smuggler can escape on the ferry. I suggest you send them on a wild goose chase or get them to fight each other instead of attacking them directly. But I'll leave the decision in your hands. So long as I get my package intact and unharmed, I'll be happy. For your assistance, I'll pay you each 2,500 New Yen."
That's a lot. That's a lot of money.
Wait a minute. I don't think that's... a whole lot of money. I think more money would be better than that.
Ah.
Am I doing this right?
Very wise.
We want more money. Sorry. How much more? I don't know. How much more?
Tell him to triple it.
Triple it!
You drive a hard bargain. Okay.
Yes! Yes!
Krabsy dances around.
I did it! I've never actually made one of those before!
It's fantastic.
Alright. Well, I guess we get going to the ferry docks then, huh? Okay. Load up, chummers! Oh boy. All right.
I'm enjoying this as much as Krabsy is.
Okay, and...
he's so confused what's going on. Poor Ludo's just like...
just mostly concerned with eggs on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah, just kind of like... so out of his element, right?
Right.
Pretending to be a decker, but like kind of too dumb to know what a decker does.
Mm-hmm.
Just kind of, what, yeah.
That's a good point.
Yeah,
perfect. All right.
I'll hack something?
I'm sure there's going to be lots of stuff to hack, probably just later on, though. Don't worry, we're going to be making a lot of good use out of your out of the Decker. The Decker is probably one of the most important members of the team. It's my understanding from reading some of the literature. There's a lot of bonus things that he can do, attacks that he... Let's go to the ferry terminal! All right!
Yeah.
And so the world kind of vanishes and the woman starts loading up the next one. You guys see a couple of cars, two cars, pull up into the parking lot. You guys all see this.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Because these are very...
So I pop the AR goggles up. This is a real thing? There are really cars showing up there?
Yeah. Those are actual cars.
Okay.
And
well,
you know...
make sure they don't dent my food truck.
They look good. A little strange because they are... they're literally clown cars.
Oh my god, no.
They're literally clown cars. You watch them pull up, and Mr. Johnson's like, hey, sorry guys, this is gonna take just a second. We gotta, we're experiencing a little bit of a communication breakdown between here and the main server, so we're gonna get you back online here in no time at all, right? All right, cool, all right. And
what?
So the VR is like
this,
down?
So I want to ask, do I recognize this as a serious gang that we should be worried about?
Oh, yeah. It's the Halloweeners.
It is the Halloweeners?
That's right. That's what I figured, but
yes.
I didn't know if that's what Moonbiter figured.
You figured that out.
Guys, I think we have a problem. Those are Halloweener cars.
That's not good.
I roll stealth.
So yeah, let's go ahead and take some actions here. What do you guys do? They are
escape artists
piling out of the they're piling out of the clown car. There's seven of them in these two tiny little cars. Or I should say six. There's six in each of these two tiny little cars.
They have weapons?
Jason's mom. I'm sorry. I apologize. I didn't catch your name.
Huh?
Your name? We need to go.
Oh, yeah. You can just call me Debbie.
Oh, Debbie. Wonderful. Okay. Those cars just pulled up. That's a serious street gang. We should leave.
Oh.
All of us. Now. No.
Serious street gang.
I...
You guys. Okay. All right. I'm going to go over by the playground. You guys have your fun, okay?
Okay. Where is the playground?
The playground is over here.
Which figure is she?
She
Can
is,
I grab her just one. By the collar?
Oh, ow. Hey, easy there, big man.
Just... I think we should listen to him.
I know. I'm in on it. I'm gonna go over by the playground.
What do you mean? No, I don't let it. What do you mean you're in on it?
It's fine. You guys have your fun, okay? I'm not gonna get in the way.
We should probably just lead them away from this park entirely because there's a ton of civilians around here.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Let's go.
Grabsy.
Yeah.
I'll put her down.
Grabsy, do you see those over there?
Grabsy, I don't think
those are real, aren't they?
I don't think this is part of the game.
Okay.
John, can you
oh god, we're parked over there.
Oh my god, there's so many.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, I'm gonna attempt to round up all of the civilian performers and stuff.
Hey man! You guys all took your goggles off. I think we're back ready to go online.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Hey, could you bring everybody over here for a second? I want to talk about a surprise we might have for Grabsy, if that's okay.
Yeah, man, cool. Here, you can talk to my associate, Megan. I can't drop character, dude.
I know, that's fine. Megan.
She's like, yes?
Look over there, you see those guys? Are they with you?
No.
All right, this is going to turn real ugly.
They all have clubs
then
and knives.
Then we all need to go now.
You need to get everybody down. This is a safety issue.
Okay.
Go out.
Hey, Jordan, I think we need to get...
go out towards the playground.
I think we need to get moving here. Let's probably just leave the duffel.
Leave the other... Go, just leave the duffel right now. Leave it. Just leave. Go.
Okay. Oh, no.
All right. Yeah, and let's see, where's which one is Jordan? That's you, right? This is Jordan right here. Okay.
Pink is mini.
Sorry.
Oh my gosh.
If you want to schedule like a session, I'm happy to.
Yes.
To do some painting.
No, just I actually have paints that I purchased specifically for this.
Cool.
Dude, what? How, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, hit me, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
You know, I'd love to hang out and just paint minis for a couple hours or something.
There are 12 Halloweeners. 12.
All right.
Have you never taken
on 12 Halloweeners before?
This is so loud.
We're all gonna die.
Where's the mother? Did she go with them, or is she?
Yeah, they're all over here, and the Halloweeners
are there.
Eggs, eggs. They're over there, though.
Yeah, they sort of spread out. And I guess
this is so this is Grabsy, this is you.
You know, I might go tail them just to make sure they get out safe, so I might follow them. And like, you have stealth, you have things at your disposal, right? You have abilities or something.
Well, we'll see. I think right now we just kind of want to get everybody that away. Mm-hmm.
I might go with them and make sure that they get that away. Just I can block them if they.
Is Grabsy's mom and the people now sort of like behind those buildings and they can't see exactly what happens?
They are. He is pushing them over in this. So Jordan is kind of acknowledging what's going on, and he is pushing them over this way, and these guys don't seem too concerned.
I'm gonna try to indicate for Grabsy to come my direction too, toward the buildings. Because a decker out in the middle of a field is not probably the best idea.
This guy, what's you?
Hey, what are you guys doing? Yeah, that's what I thought you were doing.
So, there's a guy. Steps up.
I gotta get to that van.
Yeah, are they not? So they're not really paying attention to him because he's Eggman or Pikachu.
He is not on the list.
So he's coming out alone.
What's that?
He's coming out by himself.
Wait, they're really letting me through?
Yeah.
Oh yes. Where's my van?
Huh? Your van is in the parking lot.
Is this big white one?
Yeah,
right
it's
here?
The big white one.
There you go.
So I disappear inside.
Okay.
I want to shout out to the guy who's whistling, this guy who appears to be in charge.
This guy is whistling.
Oh, that guy's whistling. Okay.
But this guy is the one who steps out. He has got a Tommy gun and a fedora and very finely tailored suit.
So he's not dressed like a Halloweener?
Yeah, he is.
Oh, okay.
He's dressed like a very nicely dressed Halloweener. It's still a bit distressed.
So he's wearing like the Jack Nicholson suit,
yeah,
clown thing.
Sort of like a zoot suit.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, great. Yeah, like a 1920s like Chicago gangster.
Okay. And then the rest of them are just in various other weird Halloweener costumes,
or are they all kind of themed
in a sort of gangster theme?
No, it's all over the place. They're all sort of. There's a
so there's a guy dressed like Zardoz. There's
a French maid.
Right.
There is a guy dressed up in the Tron outfit.
He's just very retro.
Yeah. Super retro.
Right.
But he's
right.
A little overweight.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. He's literally just like Tron guy.
He's frizzing. Okay. He's popping off his back from the rolls.
So
there's a Numa guy. Chocolate Rain is there.
Tay's on day.
Quick question. Is there a style of dress that the leader of a particular squad of gangers for the Halloweeners would identify himself? Like, can I clearly identify that this guy is the head of the pack?
Give me a street gang.
You want sprawl gangs?
Yeah, sprawl gangs. Okay. These are sprawl gangers for sure.
How long does it take to don armor?
That's a good question.
3 successes.
Three successes. With that, this guy, especially given the fact that he has sort of separated himself from the group,
okay,
and he is approaching you, he seems to be the voice of the gangers.
Do we have like headsets? I guess we're not like geared up for anything, right?
I mean, you were going to meet your Johnson.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So we would have.
I think
in a public park, so I doubt we're totally strapped. But you, probably don't have a problem because I think all of your weapons are concealed in your arms.
Right. I think everybody except for Gidget. You guys are all pretty easily able to easily conceal. Like Ketu has knives.
I think I wouldn't be rocking the scorpion, but I certainly have the holdout, and I probably have the collapsible staff and baton.
Yes.
Because that would be just a standard thing I would carry.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, stuff you can easily conceal.
Well, okay. If this guy's coming out, I'm gonna cross the field to try to like go meet
him. I want to call out to him. I'm going to call out to him.
You going to call out?
Yeah. Hey, I think that's far enough. You want to tell us what this is all about?
Nah, wise guy,
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I'm gonna pump your body so full of lead that you're gonna be using your dick as a pencil!
I'm gonna give you one chance to walk away right now. I don't care what this is about. I don't wanna know what this is about. But this is not the time or the place for this kind of bullshit.
Can I roll an etiquette real fast?
Yeah.
I'm armor gear up montaging in my food truck.
When you need to put on clip, there's a montage.
Yeah, helmet on.
All right, three successes.
Three successes, and that is, I believe etiquette is a opposed test.
And first impressions plus two.
Oh yeah,
is that roller successes?
This is gonna be dice, etiquette modifiers.
Because I think everything is pretty much dice. Rarely just give out free successes.
Oh well.
Using etiquette 141. So, I wish they would just list these. Perception.
No, wouldn't it be nice?
Test against the other person's perception plus charisma.
Oh, just a full list of opposed rolls.
Okay.
Or
yeah, right.
Any sort of a way of.
Like, how helpful would that be?
Hey, Tops, I love you, and you put out a fine quality product. But we're just asking if you could tweak the usability of that index just a little bit.
There it is. Okay.
Maybe put some hyperlinks into that PDF or something so that you can click on all those page numbers and.
More catalyst than Tops.
Oh, sorry.
How many successes did you get?
Tops owns Catalyst.
Gotcha.
How many hits did you get?
Three.
Well,
three.
You can just pass that on down the line to Catalyst.
You got two hits, so you have one net hit. So what are you attempting to do here?
I'm trying to discern what the best mode of behavior is for these type of crazy people. Like, is it best to be crazy at them, or is it best to like try to de-escalate? Because I don't feel like that would work.
Or be aggressive, or...
Yeah.
You're able to you can use etiquette to ease suspicions.
Okay.
And let's see. If you get more than three net hits, their attitude toward you will improve. You didn't get three net hits, you got one net hit. So he's still hostile to you. Halloweeners are incredibly unpredictable. That's sort of their whole bag.
Yeah.
He might just call it off just as easily as he might decide to jump you guys.
The last time we met Halloweeners, I took an aggressive attack with them, and it did not work.
Right.
But that doesn't necessarily mean that they're...
Trying your best, and we're not going to see
Yeah.
We got a lot of eggs if you guys are hungry.
History repeats itself.
There's a complete lack of
fuck
eggs.
Out of here, and you know, we don't want any of the bullshit here.
He's like, hey, we got some eggs.
I'm gonna wait a half second to see how they react to that, and then see.
Okay, so what do you say to Noodles?
Well, I'm gonna wait just a half second to see what he responds to what he said.
Noodles.
Just to like catch.
So a second ago, I essentially just threatened them. I said, look, this isn't the time or the place. You don't want to do this. I'm giving you a chance to walk away. I don't know what this is about. I don't care what this is about.
Yeah. And I want to catch that split second timing to turn it around if it looks like the dude isn't taking that well.
Okay, cool. So give me an intimidation check.
I will give you an intimidation check.
Intimidation.
Intimidation.
And you're actually pretty intimidating, if I remember correctly.
I got 7 dice.
Oh, no.
So I've got
I don't have any. Oh.
The phantom fish.
Why did you do that?
Not with that, though. Sadly, that is only a single success.
And he got 2 successes.
Yeah, of course he did.
So.
Fair enough.
He goes.
And then I'll say,
you think I'm scared of you? You killed my brother!
Anyone know what the hell he's talking about?
I knew it was you! You broke my heart.
That's not
you
all
you killed
I'm
our
break.
Brothers in cold blood.
I'm gonna well, kill more of your brothers if you don't yeah. leave right now.
I ain't afraid of you, Kappa.
Take confused. I will go with the egg line then. Might as well. Jeez. All right. Yeah, we got lots of eggs if you guys are hungry.
Also biscuits and sausages. What do you think, boys? You want to eat? There's a guy with Braveheart, with a Braveheart thing.
You may take our lives, but you'll never take our bacon!
And he's like, sorry, the boys ate, but there's something else on the menu. Get it, boys? On the menu?
Oh, this is about to
get
real
a sand
bad.
Person. Here's what we're gonna do. I'll give you to the count of 10 to get your lousy, no good, rotten keisters out of here, or I'll pump you full of lead. One.
I have a quick question here. So this is like,
oh my gosh.
In terms of like actual placement. How close are they, really? Because I know we're sort of spread out, and this map has no squares yes. and
so,
to scale. And I know
so the scale is one car is 10 feet. So this is they're actually going to be. I mean, they aren't this size, but this is a representation of where they are on the battlefield. So they're about 10 feet apart. This guy's about 20 feet apart.
Oh, so they're really spread out.
Yes. Yeah. So I mean, they're within visual range of each other, but like 10 feet. I don't know. 10 feet's like from here to the door, right?
What do I know of like what kind of equipment you have, Ketu? Do you have like smoke bombs and stuff?
I knock an arrow.
Do you knock an arrow? And would I know that you had one?
I have smoke you,
they're
grenades.
They're ignoring you completely.
Thermal smoke grenades.
Yeah, I got a 6
high
on stealth
explosive
roll.
Grenades.
Ooh, nice.
Do you want me to do 6 hits? Do you want me to declare every roll I make?
Because I would need to. That, a stealth is an opposed check.
Yep.
So
after you look that up, I have another quick question for you.
Okay.
All
kinds
grenades.
Of grenades. That's good.
Right in the middle of the day.
I think it's opposed. I think it is intuition, perception versus stealth.
Yes, opposed using perception plus intuition.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Trying not to fall asleep. I'm so sorry.
I know. I'm so
it's
sorry, Michaela.
It's not your fault.
No, it is my fault.
It's not.
You didn't get enough sleep last night because I kept calling you.
Yeah.
I kept IMing you, and I was like, Makayla, hey.
Are you ready for the game tomorrow?
I'm so excited for the game.
I'm so excited.
Aren't you excited for the game tomorrow, Makayla? I'm excited for the game.
It's only Tuesday, right? Today's Tuesday?
Today is Tuesday.
Today is for another about an hour and 20 minutes.
Okay, look at that.
Oh.
It's a nice
one.
We got some nice new stuff.
I've had a long couple of days at work, so I'm sorry.
Well, you're doing good work there. Okay, so perception is.
How does this thing
intuition
work?
Then?
How does hard is
default on intuition?
Work?
You rolled 6 what hits. Okay, he only gets 2
jacket
dice. So
shirt?
Not at all.
The hood.
A little bit of everything. It's got a hood.
I'm a shaman.
You sure are.
Okay,
but yeah, it's just
beard and hood.
2.
Whoa. High explosive grenades.
So okay, so I have 2 mechanics questions.
Okay.
So that I understand here. One is it you can take one complex action or 2 simple actions? Is
correct.
That the math
yes.
is right there?
Per combat pass.
Okay. Per combat pass. And then if something says that it has it has an effect that happens every combat turn, is that one pass, or is that until everybody is out of initiative when we roll initiative the second time?
The second one.
Is that right? Well, that's not as useful as I had hoped.
I am going to just say, Ketu, smoke, and then.
Ten!
One, two, ten. Nice. All right.
Yeah, I guess I should have figured that out.
Yeah, that's what he does in the movie.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Oh, I forgot about that. That's what he did in the.
So, we have 20 minutes left. Mm-hmm.
Do we want to
engage?
Fade to black for now?
I believe that we are going to have to call it early for tonight. Yeah. We are going to prepare next week. We're going to bring a Red Bull.
Yeah.
And we are going to blindfold Makayla and pour the Red Bull down Makayla's throat.
Oh my God.
And Makayla is going to hate us, but at the end she's going to thank us.
And then one of us is going to blow a whistle really loud in your ear while another one shakes your chair.
I am afraid to have an energy drink.
Do you have like a heart problem?
No.
Need some coffee or something.
Then you're going to, it's going to be a fun night.
Eventually they don't even want anything anymore.
For us, yes, what? Exactly.
I have one of those.
I think so I've tasted one energy drink and it tasted like liquid sweet tarts.
Sounds about right.
Yep. All right, guys. So thank you, everybody, for joining us. Thank you for followers.
Thanks, guys.
And resubs. I believe that was S House Studio, Ret 9, Dirk Portley with the resub, the Bard 1971 for the donation, and Carlos Cub Star for the follow. You guys are awesome. Thank you for watching. Thank you for liking and subscribing our content. And we'll just go spin around the room real quick and everybody give out their social hashtag. So if you want to follow us on the social medias, you can do so. I'll start with myself. I am Boring Old Tyler on both Twitter and Instagram.
Unfollow
Tyler. Hashtag unfollow Tyler.
Let's see. I'm on Twitter. I have yet to start doing anything on it, but it's Jesse A. Durant at Jesse A. Durant.
You don't even know how to use Twitter.
Give him some followers, man. Be his first follower.
Yeah, you could be. And then eventually.
I was following him before he was cool.
I'm following him right now.
It's going to get crazy.
It's going to be a cry. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, cool.
I am on that camera. I am Scissorbot on Instagram and Twitter. But I am also Twitter inactive.
You have a scissor tattoo.
Yeah, it was a company logo, and then I decided that I didn't like running a company. So now it's just a logo. And it's a tattoo. A
pair of scissors in a film.
That's right.
Yeah. Nice.
Awesome. Okay, who are you? Where can we find more of this wonderful Makayla-ness?
I am Geek Your Heart Out on both Instagram and Twitter.
And that's a Geek Her Heart Out, right?
For one of them.
Yeah.
On Twitter.
Twitter.
Hey, Tom.
Ur, as in the ancient Babylonian city.
Yeah.
Awesome. All right. Last but not least.
I'm Nick. You can find me on Twitter at Sungrowler. I also am occasionally tweeting about this game as at Street Shaman, at Sprawl Shaman. Do you remember?
I remember. Moonbiter Shaman, I believe.
Yeah, just check out Moonbiter Shaman. I'm pretty sure there aren't going to be very many of those out there in Twitter, but hop on that if you want. Give me a follow, and sometimes I talk back and forth with Grabzy.
Yeah, they have a good time. Oh, yeah, and that's Go number 4, Grabzy, is the official Twitter account of Hoy Chummer, where Grabzy sort of updates you on all the goings-on of of the Hoy Chummer crew.
It's so good.
Check that out, and...
I have one more.
One more.
Me too, actually.
I just wanted to say, we've been trying to get it out there. If anyone is in the greater Los Angeles area, the Strategic Con of cons is happening this weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, at the LAX Hilton, so please come on out. We do have some of the Saving Throw GMs who are running games. We'd love to come and meet you in person. I believe that is GM Mace, Stephen Pope, and Wes Otis from other shows that we have during the week. And we'd love to see you, and come say hi.
Good looking out.
That's great.
Cool. Oh, and I'm also on Instagram as just Jesse Durant without that A.
Ah,
so.
You managed to add that one.
Yeah.
I'm the fake Jesse.
I don't even have to put the real Jesse.
Oh, nice.
Jesse
Grant official.
One more thing. If you guys like what you saw tonight and you like Shadowrun podcasts, this is just a personal recommendation. I'm watching I'm listening to a podcast called Crit Squad, C-R-I-T Squad. They do a fantastic job. They have a very interesting and well-run podcast, a lot of like audio post-production stuff, which you never see in podcasts. Awesome. It's all condensed, it's tight, it's sharp, it's professional. If you guys want to get more Shadowrun and it goes very quick, check out Crit Squad. I believe they're on Facebook and Twitter and shortwaverady.io. I believe is their website. So they're cool guys. I've never met them, but I listen to them, and I think they do a good job. Anyway, that is going to be us for tonight. Check us out in 2 weeks, where we're going to see a bunch of Halloweeners murder
everybody.
The people that you've grown to know and love.
Get murdered, he means, by the people you've
just
grown
going to
love.
And also
destroy. Yeah. We have the high ground. Okay.
Shouts. Is there one all in robes with the...
Yes. Yeah, oh God, oh, there is
a claymore or whatever.
an actual monofilament sword.
Yeah, thing. Oh God.
Nice.
Oh. But it like has LEDs so it lights up.
Thanks.
That is content.
Thanks,
right
Nick.
There.
Yeah, great. Okay. Now they're all going to have monofilament swords.
I know, now I have time to actually flesh one of these ones out.
Yeah, yeah.
Fantastic. Oh. They're just going to be generic gangers. But and I'm going to be reaching out to our Patreon subscribers to help me flesh out this crew that they're going to be facing tonight. Seldon Archaeus donated tonight, and he has given me the leader of the group.
Oh, these were their names.
Yes. And
Noodles?
So, what's that?
Noodles.
Noodles. Noodles is the leader.
Great name.
Thanks, Seldon Archaeus. Oh wait, should I have to check my Twitter?
Are the rest of the gorillas in there too?
Sorry.
Yeah, I was like, what are they like? Russ. And
so if
I
you
was trying to think of their names too. I was like, yeah, something.
Yeah.
If you donate to us on Patreon, you can get to name one of these guys and give them a personality. And then such a deal!
You get to say what gets on their head.
No. He's not selling this rights. You don't get to give them a personality. You get to give Tyler the headache of keeping track of somebody and making that accent or mannerisms throughout the entire game and laugh.
Oh God! Okay, this is. Thank you, Seldon Archaeus. You guys have seen this. This is amazing. This was Seldon Archaeus.
I made my first gift.
Seldon Archaeus.
Oh,
we've been gifted. Happy Valentine's Day! Yeah. You guys are awesome, and we'll catch you in 2 weeks. And it's gonna be a bloodbath, one way or the other.